right, race fans, are you ready to get the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown underway? Our Grand Marshal Eli's got the famous words.
Drivers, start your engines!
There we go. Langley Speedway on a Thursday night. It is the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown presented by Toyota. We welcome you, the race fans, the true race fans, supporting your home track, and we appreciate it. As we start them up. All right, once again, they're about to turn them loose here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway, the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown. Steve Post has vacated the seat for just a second as we try to get Joe Moore to do some work from MRN. Hey, Joe.
I have to work again?
Well, not really. I just thought you might want to come up and say a few words to...
I'll tell you what. It has been a walk down memory lane tonight, just walking through the garage, seeing drivers and engine builders and car owners. Folks who have supported this racetrack for all the many years that it's been here, it really means a lot to come back to Langley Speedway and see the place, number one, still alive, number two, in such great shape, and number three, the opportunity to see all these folks who have come back to support this racetrack, which has been such a big part of all of our lives.
Yeah, it really has, and I know what it's like. I mean, I was away from the track for a couple of years, but you come back out here, and it's like family reunion time, yep. You know?
Everybody's still doing the same thing they always did. That is coming out and racing and loving it. And this is a very special night because, you know, as you know, the Denny Hamlin race put on hold for 2 years in a row because of all the trouble that was going on with the ownership and all the intricacies of the business part of this facility. Finally, it all happens, and this is a grand kickoff. Another track operated all last season, but this sort of really drives it in. The fact that we are here, we are back alive and well, Langley Speedway.
And a capacity crowd here on a Thursday night for a great cause and a great race shaping up. Well, Joe, I know you got a lot of relaxing to do, so I'll let you get back to that and your cold beverages, and you get to enjoy the race and not have to work tonight. Now we're going to get Steve back over here and make him work.
Yeah, get Postman back on the job here. Get Alex Hayden down there working. Mike Allen, always good to see you, buddy.
You too.
A good race tonight.
All right, man. Have fun tonight, Joe. Thank you. Joe Moore from MRN Radio. You'll hear him calling the action up in Richmond. Yes, for the Xfinity Series and the Cup Series. You'll hear Steve Post. You'll hear Alex Hayden as well. So they're getting a little warm-up for Richmond here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway, huh, Steve?
Yes, indeed. And great kickoff. Three nights of racing here in the Eastern Virginia area. And no better place to be than right here at the Larry King Law Langley Speedway as Denny Hamlin's Short Track Showdown is getting ready to go. Cars right now have rolled onto the speedway behind the pace car. And as you can see, 33 cars certainly make their way all the way around the racetrack as they get the fluids, get the tires, get everything up to temperature, and get set to go for 200 laps here this evening.
Quite a surprise to see Philip Morris start way back there in the 11th position. He's on the inside of row number six. He's got the first two wins here at the Speedway for 2018, and those were twin 75s that we kicked off on March 31st, the only late model race we got to have before these guys had to come back for the Denny Hamlin for the big race.
Philip, that red 01 car, we're going to keep an eye on him, as you mentioned. Kind of a shocker that he's outside of the top 10. He'll start in the 11th spot in the Trailer Town USA Chevrolet. And one of the mainstays, one of the top drivers in all of late model racing, former national champion with the NASCAR program. And going to be fun to watch him starting in the 11th spot. And if I were a betting man, I would bet he doesn't stay in 11th long as he rumbles his way forward up through the top 10.
Once again, it's Danny Edwards, Denny Hamlin on the front row, Kyle Busch next to Timothy Peters, the 51 and the 12. Then you got the 18 of Ty Gibbs and the 02 of C.E. Falk. Peyton Sellers, number 26, and Nick Smith in the 12S in the 8th position. Also in the top 10, Connor Hall and Justin T. Carroll driving that 57. Philip Morris in the 01 and Wyatt Snyder, that's Myatt with an M in the 2. Tyler Hughes in the 8, 83 is Matt Bowling in 14th. Ryan Vargas in the 2, 03, Butterbean, Brendan Queen. Then you got Doug Barnes in the 88 and Ruben Garcia in the 6. Mason Diaz in the 24D, Nicholas Sanchez in the 98. Quite a few Rev racing cars out here today for the late models. Brent Moffitt in the 16M, the 41 is Woody Howard. Casey Wyatt, the 92.9. And Mark Wirtz in the 55, the Dunkin' Donuts ride. Grayson Culliter in the 22. Chase Caffrey in the 4. Eddie Johnson's 57. Eddie's been racing out here a long time, and he's back. Terry Carroll in the 90. And Colin Garrett in the 24G. Justin S. Carroll, the 91. And Bubba Johnston in the 16J. 00 Chris Johnson, son of Eddie Johnson. And the 94 is Cody Carlton, the way they will kick off tonight's event here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. Presented by Toyota.
Field getting told to double up. Looks like we're about two laps from the green flag. Two laps from the green flag as we get set to go. 75 laps, the first stage in this one. And we will see what happens as the field settles in. Right now, side-by-side formation behind the Toyota pace car.
I don't know about you, Steve, but I'm all jacked up. I'm ready.
I'm telling you what, this is going to be a great, great race. This anticipation of this for the last couple of years, the race not happening, the anticipation here at Langley, it is on, and we are one lap from go time, one lap from the green flag here at the Larry King Law Langley Speedway.
Car Masters Automotive Cone Rule is in effect. And if you're new to Langley or any short track racing, once we have a caution, the cone comes out right before they turn them loose with a lap to go, and then they'll get up there on the outside if they're willing to try it. Otherwise, they'll stay down the bottom of the racetrack. That outside groove still getting worked in as that new pavement they put in the turns is still getting worked in a little bit. And, of course, the rubber being laid down, quite a lot of it was laid down today from all these cars. And what a field of race cars we've got for the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown Green Flag.
Racing down into turns one and two. Danny Edwards gets the advantage up off from the second corner. Denny Hamlin tucks down into the second spot. There's Kyle Rowdy Bush in the third spot as they race their way through turns three and four as Danny Edwards leads the first lap here at Langley.
And he's got a comfortable lead already, too. It's at least 2.5 car lengths over the number 11, the FedEx machine of Denny Hamlin, then Kyle Busch, his teammate, and it's a side-by-side battle for the fourth position. 18 dives down low.
Indeed, they are running side-by-side for the position. On the high side, Timothy Peters gets the run. Give Peters position number four as they wheel their way off from turn number two. Peters up to the fourth spot. The battle is now on for the fifth spot into turn number three.
Also a great battle as Connor Hall dives down low in the 77 machine, inches his way up next to that number two machine, and a great battle between himself and Wyatt Snyder.
Up at the front of the field, the challenge for the lead into turn number three. Edwards slides up the racetrack. Here comes Denny Hamlin. Hamlin down low, wheels that car to the inside. Give the top spot to Denny Hamlin. Takes the advantage. That puts Edwards back in the second spot. Now Kyle Busch looking for running room from third.
Timothy Peters watching these guys battle it out as he's back there in fourth, just ahead of C.E. Falk and Peyton Sellers. Ty Gibbs, Nick Smith all battle it out in a side-by-side battle as the 18 is to the outside of that two again. Myatt Snyder, good battle between those two. Oh, spin!
Trouble in turn number two as we have a car go the wrong way around down there. I believe it might be the 0-2 of C.E. Falk. If I'm not mistaken, C.E. Falk and a couple other drivers, and now we've got four or five cars stopped down there in turn number two. Some high-speed racing, and we've got a pile of them down in the first and second corner. First caution is out here as we are at lap number five.
Looks like it was also the 0-1 of Peyton Sellers getting a taste of this over there, right there at the bottom of the racetrack over in turn two. First caution flag and a lot of damage on Connor Hall's number 77 Town Bank ride as he inches his way down the back straightaway. See if we can go to the pits and get some words from those guys. Don't think Buck has got his ears on, so we'll get back to him in just a minute.
Philip Morris in the pit area. Phillip Morris brings his car into the pit. The crew working on the left side of that car. That's the problem with starting in the 11th spot. Someone gets in trouble in front of you, and you get in trouble. It looks like Alex Hayden is making his way to check out the Phillip Morris pit stop.
More got some bodywork damage there. There's Mason Diaz. He's got a big ding in the left side right in the middle of the 24. The hood of his black and blue Solid Rock Carriers entry is all bowed up. They go to work on that. Looks like cosmetic damage only for Mason Diaz. Much the same for Philip Morris down here. Left front cosmetic damage only. No problem with the steering. No problem with the suspension, it appears, for Philip Morris. No bit to get him back on the racetrack. You mentioned the other driver that had some significant contact, Connor Hall. The left side of his race car completely bashed in. As a matter of fact, the body panel, driver's side door, is completely caved in. They're having to change the left rear tire as it was completely flat. So an awful lot going on here after a skirmish over there in turns one and two here at Langley Speedway.
Woody Howard bringing that 41 car in. A lot of damage to the front end of that. Looked like someone just hauled off with a baseball bat and whacked it right in the front. Damage on the right front of that and on the nose of that race car as the crew goes to work on that white and red number 41 car.
Woody Howard, one of those guys that has a win in the Denny Hamlin, actually in the Hampton Heat race, but he knows how to get some victories out here. And there he sits on pit road with a lot of damage on his automobile. 77, Connor Hall is going to take it back out in the Town Bank machine, and also Mason Diaz continues to sit on pit road as they give attention to the front of his automobile. Cody Carlton as well in the 94.
Hey guys, had a little bit of a dust up between crew members already. One of Philip Morris's crew members and one of the crew members from Connor Hall got into it. They shoved each other in the chest a couple of times before they were separated. The reason being is because the work was complete on Connor Hall's car before Philip Morris. As a matter of fact, Morris still sitting here on the pit lane, and they're basically wedged in. There's no pit boxes here, so they have to basically stop on their own. Well, Connor Hall tried to make the hard right turn to pull out, had to put it in reverse, and one of the crew members for Connor Hall went up and gave a shove to the back end of Philip Morris's car, and obviously that brought the ire of some of these crew members down here, but a little bit of a dust-up between crew members already.
Also see Casey Wyatt is on pit road making some adjustments to his number 92, and they're going to work on the right side. Didn't see him get involved in the wreck. Not sure if he ran over anything or what the case is with Casey. First caution flag here on lap five. Didn't take long, did it, Steve?
No, it didn't. And I think that's the nature of the racing. Everyone was scrambling for spots. We saw a couple of cars watching Ty Gibbs, the driver of that number 18 car. He was having trouble pinning it down. And when opportunity arises, I think drivers taking advantage of it. And then the next thing you know, one car steps out and everyone is so on the gas and so amped up and ready to go at the beginning of this thing. And so tightly packed as well that when a one car accident happens, well, you have a multiple car accident. I mentioned C.E. Falk, I thought was at the beginning of that, and C.E. still out on the speedway and rolling around in his position. So, missed call on that. So, C.E. Falk fans, he apparently was not in that crash. Thought it was his car and that started it, but it was not C.E. Falk, and he continues on now. C.E. is running in position number five out on the speedway. So, good to see it was not him involved in that accident.
Looks like the 0-1. Trailer Town Machine, Philip Morris is about to come back out. He involved in that wreck along with Connor Hall, Woody Howard, Mason Diaz, Cody Carlton, and Ty Gibbs in the 18. And they still continue a little bit of cleanup at the exit of turn two. Let's go down to the track and see if we can get a word.
Yeah, the damage is severe for Woody Howard at the nose of his red and white Ford. The good news, however, is it did not puncture the radiator, as the entire nose has been peeled up, but they're going to try to put some tape on that to hold it down, hold the hood in place. It's not a very pretty looking nose of this Ford, but it is mechanically fine, so Woody Howard will be able to go out. Important to note that as long as you're down here on this pit lane and this caution flag, you're going to stay on the lead lap. Caution flag laps do not count until after the third caution of the race. So all these teams can take their time as long as this caution flag is out and make sure they get their cars put back together.
Best winners of this Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown include Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, Tony Stewart, and C.E. Falk and Matt Bowling.
Drivers choosing their lane, and it appears that Kyle Busch has chosen the outside. Looks over at his teammate, Denny Hamlin, side-by-side on this thing. So what do you think of this front row as Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch going to go after it here in another lap?
Timothy Peters went to the outside, so did Nick Smith. Ryan Vargas in the two, another driver that took the Car Masters cone. And they've got the light on again on the pace car. The Toyota Camry, of course, Toyota, sponsoring tonight's event here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway as they get set to turn them loose. Up front, the Cup regulars, Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch, will lead the field as we go back to green. Still one more lap. Danny Edwards on the bottom of the racetrack back there in the second spot with the Danny's Glass Chevrolet. He's behind Danny in the 26.
He always wants out right now. As Kyle Busch is up there, Timothy Peters is up there. If any drivers can make it work, we're going to see what that outside lane looks like right now. Track caution lights are out. The pace car, the Toyota Camry pace car, going to get out of harm's way in turn number four. It's Denny Hamlin on the inside. And it is Kyle Busch on the outside. Green lights are on racing. Hamlin with a pretty good jump at the start as they wheel him off into turn one and two. But here comes Kyle Busch on the high side. Side by side on the back straightaway as they continue on wheel to wheel into turn number three.
Timothy Peters, he tries to stay a little wound up with them. They're three wide at the exit of four. One has to fall back, and that is the 12. That's Nick Smith.
On the outside, it's Kyle Busch getting the run by a half a car length. This Kyle Busch by a car length. He slides down across the nose of Denny Hamlin. New leader, Kyle Busch, leads across the stripe. Denny Hamlin is right there. They continue side by side. Edwards and Peters wheel to wheel for the third spot.
Rallies out front is Denny Hamlin in the second spot, about 2.5 car lengths back to a side-by-side battle, and a great one, too, with Danny Edwards on the bottom, Timothy Peters on the high side, and he makes the pass, takes over third spot.
Outside lane definitely worked out there. Kyle Busch able to take the first spot, and Timothy Peters able to take the third spot, but it took some time. It took some effort. Took a lot of whittling away at it, but right now here they come. Kyle Busch is the race leader. Denny Hamlin is second spot. Timothy Peters runs in third, running in the fourth spot. is Danny Edwards. And running in position number five, C.E. Falk. Falk looking to the low side, right on the back bumper of Edwards.
Gives him a little bit of a shove right there in the middle of the turn in between three and four. Inches up right next to Danny. And now between one and two, it's a side-by-side battle for the lead again.
Indeed, Denny Hamlin just blasts around the outside of Kyle Busch. Give Hamlin the top spot back. Don't know if Kyle got out of shape down on the inside, pinched it off a little bit. But right now, Denny Hamlin back to the point. Hamlin leads. Kyle Busch in second. Timothy Peters is in the third spot. C.E. Falk is fourth. Running in the fifth spot is Greg Edwards. And Peyton Sellers actually moves up to the fifth spot. So Sellers on the move in that 26th car.
Danny Edwards falling back a little bit to the clutches of the two. Once again, that's Ryan Vargas, one of those Rev Racing cars. Kyle Busch hanging right with Denny Hamlin up front. Great battle for the second spot. Timothy Peters trying to hold off C.E. Falk, but C.E. Falk's got the bumper of his machine down on the inside on the 12.
C.E. Falk started in the sixth spot, and he has made his way up to the fourth spot. Now he's looking to the inside of Timothy Peters off turn number two. C.E. Falk is there into turn number three. Falk, a former winner of this race, and he is looking stout in the early going here as he works to the inside for the third spot.
C.E. Falk, a Langley Speedway champion, multiple-time champion. He makes the pass on the 12. He brings the 26 with him, Peyton Sellers, looking to move up another position as they battle for the fourth spot. Danny Edwards watching these guys. He's falling back a little bit from the pole. And sparks flying from underneath the 26, Peyton Sellers.
Peyton Sellers, that famous car, the Danville Toyota sponsorship on it, but also Clarence's Steakhouse on the nose of that car. And Clarence's Steakhouse has been owning Clarence Pickerel, his own late model cars, probably as long as there's been late model cars around here. Right now, he's got to be happy. Peyton Sellers has that number 26 car in the fourth spot as they settle in now into the top five as we work our way down to complete lap number 16. 16 laps have been completed.
One caution flag happened on lap five. They get it settled down a little bit. There's some side-by-side racing a little bit back through the field, but it seems like you get caught on that outside, you're going to go to the rear.
Indeed, a couple of drivers getting together off turn number four, but everyone able to straighten it out, and it does look like the margin at the front of the field is closing back up again. Denny Hamlin is the leader, but Kyle Busch bird-dogging him down into turn number one. Those sparks fly out from underneath Kyle Busch's car. He's about a half a groove lower than Denny Hamlin is right now. Not only does Denny Hamlin have Kyle Busch on the back bumper, he's got one lap car, and lap traffic could very well be a factor here as we get rolling here and start to string some laps together.
Matt Bowling, that 83, he's got a mirror full. I mean, that 57 is all over him. Justin T. Carroll, a little bit further back through the field. We've got one car that's a little bit off the pace that makes its way around. That is the 41 of Woody Howard.
Right now, laps being logged here at the Larry King Law Langley Speedway. Denny Hamlin is the race leader. Kyle Busch runs in second. C.E. Falk doing a nice job from sixth to third here. Peyton Sellers runs in the fourth spot. Timothy Peters runs fifth. Danny Edwards, Myatt Snyder, Tyler Hughes, Justin T. Carroll, and Matt Bowling, your top 10 racers as we complete lap number 21. But lap traffic is getting closer and closer to the front windshield of Denny Hamlin.
Following that top 10 in the 11th position, Ty Gibbs and Ryan Vargas, Ruben Garcia, Nick Smith, and Brendan Queen, the top 15. Colin Garrett, Nicholas Sanchez, Doug Barnes, and Grayson Culliter, 19th, and Mark Wirtz in the top 20. Out of the 33 cars we have competing for the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown. And the 0-1 moving back up through the field even after that wreck. He's not slowing down, though. I'm talking about Philip Morris in the 0-1.
Philip Morris started in position number 11, was involved in that first lap crash. Right now finds himself in the 21st spot, and he is rumbling through the field. Right now working his way off from the final corner, and Philip Morris doing a nice job there, working in the number 21 spot, and he is trying to work his way back up to the front of the field after that lap five dust-up.
We will have a break at lap 75. They can do a four-tire change and make some minor adjustments. And I think they're going to be making some major adjustments of some of these cars a little bit further back through the field. Good battle over here between the 98 and the 88 on the back straightaway. But everywhere you look, we've got some good battles as people continue to close in on each other. But I think, for the most part, they might be trying to save some tires, too.
Well, business is about to pick up at the front of the field because Denny Hamlin, it was a full straightaway. It was a half a straightaway. Now it's about three car lengths to the back of the field, and it is about a half a car length off the back bumper where Kyle Busch is. And C.E. Falk is there as they race their way into lap traffic here. As we complete lap number 28, Denny Hamlin looks low. Kyle Busch looks to the high side. They're side by side.
And the lap car doesn't look like it knows where to go. It stayed on the inside for the most part. Then he forced his way down on the bottom and was able to get by, but it allowed Kyle Busch to close up on the back bumper of that number 11 FedEx machine.
Kyle Busch right there on the back bumper now settles into the tire tracks, about 10 car lengths to the next pack of lap traffic. Denny Hamlin slides up, not able to do anything there. They work their way into turn number 3. Denny again about a half a car length higher than Kyle Busch off turn number 4.
Just had a gaggle of cars go between 1 and 2 and a spin right there in the middle of 1 and 2, and the caution flag is out for the second time.
Yellow flag is out. One car sitting the wrong way around down in turn number 1. And I don't know. I bet you Denny Hamlin's pretty happy that that lap car came out.
Yeah.
He's fixing to get real busy there. If that first lap car was any indication, I can't imagine what would have happened if they caught a pack of lap cars. But, caution is out.
It was about to be a rat's nest he was going to weave through. And he didn't really have too much. He didn't really know which way to go on that double zero. The double zero, I thought, was going to go to the outside, but he cut back down on the inside, down the bottom of 1. Let's go to the pits. See if we can get a word with some of these guys. We got the 94, Cody Carlton.
Yeah, some of the spin was number 4 car out there in turns 1 and 2, and didn't catch anything, didn't look like any bodywork problems for him at all. But listening to some of the radio chatter down here, Kyle Busch said the car's not too bad. He just needs it to get up off of the corner a little bit better. He was a little surprised by that bonsai outside move that Denny Hamlin put on him a few laps ago that you guys described perfectly. So Kyle Busch went to school on that. Said, you know what, there may be an opportunity to have a second lane a little bit later on in this race.
Or as Denny showed, you can do it early in the race. Yeah, it's been pretty entertaining so far. We've only got 29 laps out of 200 complete. Once again, we've got that break at lap 75 and again at 150.
Field rolling around the speedway behind the Toyota Camry pace car. Track crews have moved back to their position. Right now, I believe scoring officials are making sure that the cars are in proper order before we put the car master's cone out to decide who is going to choose inside lane or outside lane. Found it fascinating that last time that Kyle Busch was able to make the outside lane work and Timothy Peters was able to make the outside lane work as well. So it may not be the quick way for the full length of the run, but it may be the way to make a move, and we'll see who chooses where and what when that car master's cone gets back out on the front straightaway.
And it looks like Chris Johnson, the 00, will get his lap back. He will be the lucky dog. And we've got a few cars coming to the pits. Mark Wirtz is on pit road in the 55. And there is Woody Howard. He had that damage from that earlier wreck on lap 5. And also the 4, Colin Cabrie, the reason for the most recent caution flag. Here's Alex.
Yeah, Cabrie is in. They are going to just make a slight adjustment on the left rear of that truck, or car rather. It's going to be an air pressure adjustment for Colin Cabrie. He said the car just way too loose in the middle of the corner. You mentioned Howard. He was part of that big skirmish back on lap number 5. And the nose of the car completely bowed up. Taking the opportunity to come in since they will not lose a lap. This is caution number 2. Caution flag laps start counting after the 3rd caution, so that the opportunity to come in and work on this just a little bit more without the problem of losing a lap.
All right, once again, the car master's cone will come out here in about 2 laps, it looks like. It's the 00, Colin Cabrie. Make that... Colin Cabrie. Colin was one of the guys involved in the wreck. It's Chris Johnson, the 00, who gets his lap back.
Field in double file formation.
Denny Hamlin goes to the outside once again on Kyle Busch. We'll have the same show we just had, but we'll see what happens this time. Man, these restarts are exciting.
Track caution lights are out. Toyota Camry pace car going to make the hard left-hand turn off turn number 4. Denny Hamlin choosing the high side. Kyle Busch choosing the inside. Here we go off turn number 4. We'll see who gets the run. Kyle gets a good run down on the inside. Denny on the outside. as they work their way into turn number one, off from turn number two. Denny Hamlin by half a car length. Denny Hamlin by a car length now. We'll see if he can slide down in front of Kyle Busch. While they're doing that, here comes the number 26 car working the highway. Peyton Sellers working around the outside of Kyle Busch, battling for second spot.
Man, that was a little tiptoe, a little finesse by the number 11 of Denny Hamlin to make that pass on the 51. Barely able to get in front of him, but he's cleared him now by two car lengths. And a great battle back there for the third, fourth, and fifth position, side by side.
Peyton Sellers tried to make the outside work on Kyle Busch, lost a couple of spots. C.E. Fault got through. Now here's Timothy Peters looking to the inside of the racetrack in that number 12 car. Sellers trying to get down onto the inside, and as a matter of fact, does. Drops down in the fourth spot. They all get jammed up between turns three and four, able to hang onto those race cars, but a little bumper tag there. As Peyton Sellers runs in the fourth spot, Timothy Peters runs in fifth.
Some very fast speeds. We're talking laps 15.819 miles an hour is 89.048. That was on lap three from Denny Hamlin. So these race laps, they're going by pretty fast. And they'll have a chance to change some tires, too, on lap 75.
33 laps have been completed. Here they come off turn number four, completing lap number 34. Great racing all the way back through the field. Some side-by-side battles. Off turn number four, you see a couple cars going side-by-side, working their way through. Then following the trials and tribulations of Philip Morris. He was 21st the last time we checked in. Philip Morris in the 17th spot, and he's looking for more on the inside. That red and white double zero car coming off from turn number four. Philip Morris, give him the 16th spot. So started 11th. Had a spin on lap number five, went to the back of the field, but Philip Morris is back up to the 16th spot and racing his way forward. As a matter of fact, car spins in turn number three right in front of Philip Morris, and around he went, and they're still piling.
The 18 plows into the stop machine. Wow. Another caution flag. Ty Gibbs. And he was a couple of laps. I was going to mention the fact that he was really squirrely on the outside, and he just couldn't get that car stopped in time, and he ran right into the number two. And it looked like he was having a pretty good run, too, Ryan Vargas.
Yeah, I was watching Philip Morris work his way forward there, and that just happened right in front of where we were looking, and Philip kind of was looking to the inside. And the number two car of Vargas just stepped out on him down into the corner. Philip Morris was already committed to the inside, so he cleanly made it through. But as you can see over there in the turn, and now we've got some fluid down on the speedway as a radiator has been trashed on one of those cars. So going to be a little bit of some time as they work to clean the racetrack up over there in turn number three, as a lot of fluid on the speedway.
Let's go down to Alex.
Brett Moffitt going to be out of the race. The left front's completely busted up. The left front wheel is completely turned sideways. The suspension is broken. He's already got the belts off of his car or off of his chest. He'll be making his way out of the race car. We'll grab a word. While we wait for him to pop out of the race car to talk to him, we want to welcome another Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series driver on hand, hanging out, watching some racing from Joe Gibbs Racing. Eric Jones is in the house with us tonight, hanging out, watching some of tonight's race. Says, NASCAR Camping World Truck Series driver Brett Moffitt gets out of the car. Brett, that's torn up pretty good. What happened?
Yeah, they just spun in front of us there. I don't know. They're being pretty aggressive for this early in the race. We just didn't qualify where we wanted. Peyton Sellers and the guys gave us a really good Toyota Camry here. And, you know, I can't thank Denny Hamlin and Toyota and Mobile One enough for giving me this opportunity. It was really fun back here, short track, late model racing, and it was for a great cause. And had a lot of fun today. Just disappointed to see it end this way and this early.
A lot of people were talking in practice that this might be a one-lane racetrack. Is there a second lane coming in?
Not quite yet. I think it's still a little too, still a little too dirty in the upper groove there. Now, if you could make up four or five lanes on the outside, it was probably worth a shot. But that leads to aggressive racing, which is we've seen a far too many cautions already this early.
No question, Brett Moffitt. Out of the race, but able to manage a smile. Of course it is. Again, all for charity racing here tonight.
Pretty cool that Eric Jones is in the house, too. Man, maybe he'll be in the next Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown.
I cannot imagine the pain that Eric Jones is in now watching a race going on and not being behind the wheel of a race car. I am telling you, that's almost like torture for Eric Jones to come up to a race and know he's not racing it. Yeah, that just got to hurt right there. It really does. Hey, want to give a shout. Brett Moffitt, great to hear from him. Great to have him here. Picked up the win of the Camping World Truck Series back earlier this year at Atlanta Motor Speedway. Doing a wonderful job over there. His second career win. Good to see Brett Moffitt back here racing on the roots on the short track here at Langley, as he is out, but great to see him here and part of the activities here tonight. I think the car that has all the damage might be the 16J of Bubba Johnson. And
Bubba Johnson, yeah, I think, yeah. I confused him with Ty Gibbs.
Yeah, Bubba's car has now been towed inside, but over in turn number three, there is a beach of cleanup. Yes, it's the Langley Beach right now over there in turn number three, as they work with that drying compound over there to try to get the racetrack and back in racing condition.
And a lap before we do that, we'll get the Car Masters cone to come out. We appreciate the new sponsorship for 2018 from Car Masters.
Car Masters Automotive, an ASE Blue Seal certified Napa Auto Care Repair Pal Top Shop. All makes and models, 2-year nationwide warranty and fair price guarantee. Rental loaner cars open until 8 p.m. weekdays and 6 p.m. Saturday. Improve your car's position by bringing it to Car Masters, or your race car's position with Car Masters Automotive, proud sponsor of Langley Speedway's Cone. Car Masters is hiring master technicians, state inspectors, and service advisors. Call 757-456-0722. CarMastersAuto.com. 931 East Little Creek Road in Norfolk. Car Masters Automotive.
While we have a chance, once again, let's go down to Alex and see if we can get a word. And he's got a lot of activity around him with a lot of different cars on pit road.
Yeah, it's quickly becoming a bit of a junkyard down here. Casey Wyatt's got his car down here. They're working on the back of his machine. They're raising the track bar on the left rear corner of his machine. Ryan Vargas out. We saw him walk by a moment ago. He's pretty frustrated with what happened. He said he talked to us just a bit. Terry Carroll also out of the race. We'll see if we can grab a comment he's got hands in pocket as he's hanging out here talking with some of the crew members to tell them exactly what happened out there. We'll let him continue that conversation. But Terry Carroll also out of the race. He's a Williamsburg, Virginia native down here. But you guys mentioned all the cleanup that's been going on. There's been 3 or 4 different radiators that have been popped out here, and they got to take some time to get some of that fluid sopped up out here.
Mosquito Joe knows that race fans don't let much spoil your time outdoors. But are you spinning your wheels when it comes to getting rid of mosquitoes? Let Mosquito Joe make outside fun again for you and your crew. Mosquito Joe treatments allow you to enjoy your yard without the nuisance of pesky mosquitoes, ticks, and fleas. No more itching and scratching, and no more wasting time on smelly products that don't work. When you call Mosquito Joe, be sure to mention Langley Speedway and receive 50% off your first spray. Visit MosquitoJoe.com or call 855-ASK-A-JOE to get started. And remember to mention Langley Speedway. With Mosquito Joe, outside is fun again.
Larry King is committed to helping those whose health, safety, liberty, or well-being have been wrongly victimized. You can have confidence in knowing you have a strong, skillful, and dedicated legal team.
Larry King knows accidents and injuries. He knows the law, and he can help. Dial 757-INJURED for Larry King.
We have nearly 40 years of trial experience and have helped tens of thousands of people for all types of serious personal injuries, criminal offenses, and other serious legal matters. Larry King Law has the knowledge, experience, commitment, and resources to be your powerful advocate.
At Toyota, we know the journey is as important as the destination. And with these just-announced offers, your first destination should be your Toyota dealer. For a limited time, take $1,500 cash back on your choice of a new 2018 RAV4 or Corolla. Or get $5,000 cash back on an Avalon. For those in search of the endless weekend, look no further than a new 2017 Tacoma with $750 cash back or 0.9% financing. Or save big with 0% APR available on many models, including new 2018 RAV4s, Corollas, and the sporty new CHR. Shop Toyota's official website for deals. Buyatoyota.com to check out all the deals this month. You can take cash back or apply toward down payment. Tacoma excludes TRD Pro. APR terms vary by model, and not all buyers will qualify. See your dealer for details. This spring, make Toyota your destination and take advantage of these amazing deals. Offers end April 30th. Toyota, let's go places.
Well, there's been a lot of talk among the Cup drivers recently, which has been a great thing for the local short tracks as they bring a lot of attention to some of these drivers at short tracks, not only in the late models, but the lower divisions too, letting you know that fun times can be had at your local short tracks.
Indeed, and it was always great to get out to the short tracks and enjoy them, whether they're asphalt tracks, whether they're dirt tracks, and it is. It's a great way to spend a Friday or Saturday night with family, with friends, and you get a chance to go down in the pits and meet the drivers and know the drivers from your community, from your neighborhood, and whether it is the division like the late models, where we see a lot of guys doing stuff with wing sprint cars over on the dirt side, but really whether it's super stocks or street stocks or bombers or grocery getters or four cylinders, everyone out having a great time racing, and I am a huge advocate of the grassroots of short track racing. As I travel around doing work with MRN Radio, I spend a lot on Friday and Saturday nights out to local tracks, and always highly entertained, always have a great time at the racetrack, and so strongly suggest that if you're not in the habit of doing it, this is the year to start. We talked down there during the pre-race show down in the grandstands, and we had a number of young kids that chatted with down there, and this is their first time at the racetrack,
right.
and that's the thing. It's like, man, it's the first time at the racetrack. Let's hope it's the first of many times here at Langley Speedway or wherever they're from, and I'll tell you, it is not a better night of entertainment than coming out to the local dirt track or the local paved track like here at the Larry King Law Langley Speedway.
And Steve, I heard you talking to one of the guys, the little guys in the grandstands, and he was talking about he didn't know if he was going to be back, but I guess he's probably changed his mind by now.
Indeed.
Yeah.
There is nothing better than Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday night stock car racing, and we've got a dandy here. Unfortunately, red flag is out. We talked about just the quantity, and Alex talked about the quantity of radiators, as I believe two of them got punctured down there. And they tried running the cars through them, but now they're bringing out some of the blowers and some of the high-intensity apparatus to get rid of some of the speedy dry down there in turn number three.
Yeah, let's see if we can get a word with Alex again.
Yeah, it's a heck of a process down here to get this track cleaned up. You got to make sure the track is in excellent shape before you turn these late model stock cars loose out there. But that's exactly what's going on out there. They're making sure that they get every bit of fluid sopped up, mopped up, and cleaned up before we can put the green flag back out there. Mentioned about three different radiators got hammered on that one. Brett Moffitt's radiator was in. Vargas's radiator was punctured in. Terry Carroll, his was as well. So, it's a process, but it's got to be done out there.
Alex Hayden stepping and fetching back there in the garage and work area, staying very, very busy down there. I think he's our herder of cats here tonight as he tries to keep an eye on everything on the racetrack and in the pit area, but none better than MRN Radio's Alex Hayden. We've got a good man in charge down there in the infield area.
Steve Post is up here in the booth with me. And, Steve, where'd you get your start in calling the races?
Dirt track racing in northeastern Pennsylvania and upstate New York, Pencan Speedway in Susquehanna, Pennsylvania, 5 Mile Point Speedway in Binghamton, New York. And I grew up actually as a little kid, though, even before that, I would announce matchbox races on the carpet or on the floor. So not a shocker when I announced to Mom and Dad that I was going to be calling races. But where the MRN impact, I used to grow up, used to have a transistor radio, and we had no local MRN affiliate. But if I positioned it just right at the right time, I could hear the legendary Barney Hall calling races. And I'm telling you what, Barney Hall calling a race will make anyone a fan. And that chase that allowed me to do it, but the local dirt tracks up in upstate New York and northeastern Pennsylvania.
That is very cool. I did some work in Selinge Grove, Pennsylvania, and had some radio station affiliation up there. But, man, the race fans in Pennsylvania, man, they are diehard. I mean... Capital letters.
They're crazy. We do a Wing Nation program, Wing Sprint Cars, the dirt track stuff on MRN. We do that every Tuesday and Thursday, and then we're on MAV TV. And Central Pennsylvania, you talk about Selinge Grove, is one of the hotbeds and not a more passionate fan base. It's like college football every Friday and Saturday night up there. It's amazing. And you mentioned Selinge Grove. Good friends of mine run that racetrack up there, and I actually get a chance to go there in a couple of weeks. When we're up at Pocono, I'm going to sneak over to Selinge Grove. They've done a lot of improvements. You Yeah, sort of like we're talking about here at Langley, the upgrades, the improvements. There's some new folks running it up at Steelens Grove. Steve Inch is the general manager, and they've moved the pit area a little bit, and they've really done a lot of improvements. So it's good to see tracks like Steelens Grove, like here at Langley, good to see tracks coming back, and that's what we're seeing at a number of places across the country. And I still wait. Do we tear down a mall to build a racetrack? I'm still waiting for the day we do that. We haven't got there yet, but I think we're getting closer and closer.
I think you might be right. And you know, you were talking about, it's funny, you talk about, you know, calling the races with the Matchbox cars and stuff like that. My son, who's 5 years old, his name is Colton, he's a huge race fan. So what he does is he sets up the Matchbox cars and all that, but he makes me call the races.
Ah, there we go. I like that. I like that. That is cool. But, you know, and that's what talking to kids, I mean, whether you want to talk about racing, whether you want to write about racing, whether you want a mechanic and work on race cars, or whether you want to drive race cars. Lots of times get contacted by people. How do we get started in racing? How do we get to work with MRN? Go to Langley Speedway on Saturday night and volunteer to help there. Volunteer to help, whether it's mechanic working on the cars, get out and do some stuff, even the iRacing. We see that if you want to drive the cars, write about the sport, officiate the sport. There's so many great opportunities, but it all starts right here at the grassroots, and this is where it all is. And I'll tell you, it's I look at the MRN crew, and every one of us has a short track background. Every one of us does. The answer for young people wanting to get involved in the sport is get out to your local weekly racing series track, Friday or Saturday night track, and get involved.
Yeah, and you know what? You can tell with you guys have a passion for it. You love doing it, and it's like a well-oiled machine when you do the races on the radio, and we appreciate being able to listen to it, too. Gives us another perspective, not just on the TV and watching it happen, but if you can't be next to the TV, and maybe you're out on a boat or you're working in the garage, whatever the case may be, it is perfect for something like that. And like I was telling Joe, you know, a lot of people, they'll turn off the sound on the TV and listen to it and listen to you guys broadcast.
And if you plan it right and you sync it up, you can sync it up during the national anthem, because that's the one time TV and radio have the same thing on. And you can hit the pause button on your TV and sync it right up to the radio, so we're right on time, too. But we do appreciate, we love our MRN listeners and all of our NASCAR fans and all of our fans of all motorsports. But we love to hear that the stories of people tuning in to MRN Radio.
About to go back to green flag racing. The cone has come out. Denny Hamlin went to the outside. So did the 12, Timothy Peters. Ryan Vargas, also another driver that went to the outside. It's Mike Allen up in the booth, Steve Post from MRN Radio, also Alex Hayden from MRN down in the pits, giving you the action tonight if you're watching it on Fans Choice. It's Langley Speedway in Hampton with a Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, C.E. Falk, Peyton Sellers, Timothy Peters in the top five. Myatt Snyder, Tyler Hughes, Danny Edwards, Justin T. Carroll, Matt Bowling in the top ten as that Toyota Camry makes the left into the pit. Steve, here they go.
Let's see what happens this time. Denny Hamlin chooses the outside. Kyle Busch down on the inside. Kyle gets the rundown into turn number one. We'll see what Denny does on the high side. He's right there alongside as they work their way off from turn number two. On the outside, here is Denny Hamlin, but look at C.E. Falk. Falk thought about making it three wide. They've got Kyle Busch trapped in the middle. Falk is nipping at his heels off the final corner.
C.E. Falk was all over the back end into the rear quarter panel on the 51 of Kyle Busch. Falls back in line. Now he's got a side-by-side battle between himself and Timothy Peters, and a big gaggle of cars now between three and four.
Yes, indeed. Timothy Peters on the outside. We've got Peyton Sellers down on the inside as they race for the four spot. Sellers gets the advantage by half a car length, but here comes Timothy Peters on the outside getting a run to see what he can do into turn number three. Not going to be enough. Peyton Sellers give him the four spot. Timothy Peters quickly hangs a left and gets down in line in fifth.
A lot of action on the racetrack, especially up here for about the 6th, 7th, 8th position as they continue to race side by side. And the caution flag is out for a spin over here on the front straightaway at the exit of 4. And that might be the 18.
Car the wrong way around out here exiting turn number 4, running back in the middle of the pack was that car, and finds himself the wrong way around. So back under caution here as we are 39 laps deep into the 200 laps that make up this race. That's a fascinating racing up at the front of the field here. The Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch shenanigans. I'm telling you, C.E. Falk.
He wants a piece of it.
C.E. Falk, I have a hunch here. It's early, and we're 39 laps into a 200-lap race. But it appears to me that C.E. Falk is ready to keep everyone honest at the front of the field. And I'm going to be fascinated to see how this race unfolds. And C.E. was right there. They about had Kyle Busch trapped in the middle there, three wide. C.E. had another foot or two, car length on the inside, and they'd have had Kyle Busch with elbows up with a whole handful there. So some great racing here at the front of the field.
Let's go to Alex.
Well, there's some team games being played at the front of the field. It's not uncommon at the upper echelon of NASCAR racing when you have teammates restarting side by side when the green flag comes back out. That's what's happening here with Kyle Busch and Denny Hamlin. Kyle let Denny from the outside lane drop down in front of him when they thing up from C.E. Falk and third on back and down here with the crew members. C.E. Falk's team told him on the radio, don't put up with the games. This isn't NASCAR Monster Energy racing. Go ahead and put the bumper on in there if they try to do that again. So hang on. This might be interesting on this next restart.
Oh. C.E. starting to show some muscle, it looks like, and trying to pick on the big boys. It's lap 41. Once again, a break coming up here at lap 75. Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown, the NASCAR Wheel and All-American Racing Series. Thursday night action instead of Saturday, but it's still just as intense. That Car Masters cone came out. And once again, it's going to be Denny Hamlin on the outside next to Kyle Busch. 0-2 down on the bottom. Once again, C.E. Falk. We'll see what he does on this restart as he's next to Timothy Peters. Peyton Sellers up there next to the 2. And Ryan. And it's lap 41. Another lap they will run around the racetrack. Danny Edwards on the outside, so is Butterbean in the 03, the 01. A Philip Morris, 55 Mark Wirtz. And about four more cars chose to use the outside cone, almost like a complete restart or the start of the race again here, Steve.
Yes, indeed. Myatt Snyder, that car in the sixth spot. And Myatt is son of Marty Snyder. You can catch Marty on NBC Sports. Marty covering the IndyCar racing right now. And Myatt, a young racer, doing a nice job here. And boy, I'm telling you what, alongside of Peyton Sellers, you can go to school racing alongside of Peyton Sellers here at Langley. Pace car takes the left-hand turn down out of harm's way. And here we go again. Denny Hamlin able to get a run around the outside. Kyle Busch is there. We'll see what happens. Kyle Busch dives down in the inside of turn number two. As they race along the back straightaway, C.E. Falk and Timothy Peters side-by-side for third.
In a side-by-side battle behind these guys, and a great run for the 11 of Denny Hamlin pulls away about a car length from Kyle Busch.
Busch runs in the second spot. That side-by-side battle for third continues. Now C.E. Falk gets about a nose out in front of Timothy Peters. Peters bails it off on the high side, gets a run in the middle of the corner. Not sure if it's going to be enough, though, as C.E. Falk about a half a car length ahead down into turns one and two for that third spot.
And C.E. pushed him up the racetrack a little bit that time in between turns one and two.
Yeah, C.E. Falk getting aggressive here early and rolls down into turn number three and able to get that spot. Timothy Peters now dives into the fourth spot. There's Peyton Sellers working in position number five. We've got Tyler Hughes and Myatt Snyder running side by side for the sixth spot. Hughes down on the inside and Hughes able to take the spot from Myatt Snyder.
Snyder falls in just in line ahead of the 0-3 of Butterbean. Then a side-by-side battle shaping up between the 0-1 of Philip Morris and the 26 of Danny Edwards a little bit further back. Danny being chased down. Back up front, it's still the 11 of Denny Hamlin, two car lengths ahead of Kyle Busch. Same distance back to C.E. Falk and about five back to our fourth place driver, the 12 of Timothy Peters.
Great racing at the front of the field. You mentioned Philip Morris. Philip Morris is in the 10th spot now and looking for more. He's on the high side, working his way into turn number three, working around the outside of Danny Edwards. Philip Morris started the 11th spot. Of course, he's a former national champion in the NASCAR Weekly Racing Series, and he started 11th, but he got involved on a lap number two mix-up and went to the back, and now he's back up to 10th spot. Change for second spot. C.E. Falk made the move to the inside of Kyle Busch. Give C.E. Falk position number two.
Once again, about 25 laps away from the break that we're... At that break point, then we'll have another one on lap one. Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, Myatt Snyder, Brendan Queen, Danny Edwards, and Philip Morris, and Justin T. Carroll 11th, Matt Bowling in 12th, Ruben Garcia, Nick Smith, and Grayson Colliter in the top 15 at this point in the race, lap 52.
Some prize money here from try to get up into the cash here as we roll along here with about 22, 21 laps to go until the end of the first stage. Right now, things have settled down about as much as they have all night long at the front of the field. The action is continues to be back there for about the ninth. Denny Edwards continues.
He's got a pretty good race car, and of course, trying to hang on to it as he is up there in the top 10. Denny Hamlin once again trying to lead C.E. Falk by a long shot. He's got at least four car lengths between himself and that 0-2, and about five back to Kyle Busch.
Right now, about a full straightaway behind the tail end of the field. So Denny Hamlin has some laps here to kind of get a rhythm, to get his pacing, to get everything down. And should this thing continue to green till lap 75, it's going to be interesting to see where we are with the lap traffic. And C.E. Falk has shown that he is being very aggressive and not taking any prisoners at all. So we'll see what happens here as we roll around the speedway. Continuing on with Denny Hamlin leading the way. And it's now down to about 20 car lengths before the lap traffic.
Scary moment between Philip Morris and Danny Edwards. Danny got hit a little bit by Philip. Moved him up the racetrack, made the pass in between one and two. He now leads the 57 of Justin T. Carroll as Danny has fallen back a couple of spots. Still a physical battle over there between one and two as the six continues to move up. Ruben Garcia.
Ruben Garcia up to about the 11th or 12th spot now as they work around the speedway. And Ruben Garcia trying to make some moves, trying to get forward there as well. Everyone racing for position. Back at the front of the field, Denny Hamlin has caught lap traffic. He has caught the tail end of the field. Got by the first car pretty quickly. And we'll see what happens with Denny Hamlin as he is now starting to get into a little bit heavier lap traffic.
Yeah, we saw that happen a little bit earlier. He almost got into a little bit of trouble when he was trying to get around that double zero. Again, a good battle over here. The 24 and the 18, and the 24 looks like to be off the pace a little bit and slowing up dramatically now as Casey Wyatt goes by. That is the 24 machine, and I think he's gathered it back up, but there for a minute, he just let off the gas and let everybody go underneath him.
Yeah, it was a handful, that's for sure, and he was able to gather it back up and stay out of harm's way, but it could have been big over there as those other cars were all over him as they raced their way off that final corner. Now they settle down, and here's Denny Hamlin continue to set the pace. C.E. Falk is gaining ground, though. C.E. Falk is about a half a car length behind Denny Hamlin here. We're at lap 64. 10 laps when they come by this time before we get there, and your front three automobiles, because Kyle Busch has caught the lead duo as well as they are closing in on lap traffic.
This is going to get good. We've got some guys racing each other hard just ahead of the leader, Denny Hamlin, and Denny closing in fast on these guys, now closes it up within 3 to 4 car lengths, but these guys nudging on each other a little bit, and they got to look in the mirror. Here comes the leader.
Denny Hamlin is the leader. C.E. Falk lost a little momentum right in the middle of the corner. Kyle Busch right there to his back bumper, but here we go. Into the lap traffic we go. Denny Hamlin, the first one to attack it. Sometimes the driver in second or third spot has the best advantage, the best vantage point of it. See, follows that lap traffic off turn number two. Now dives to the inside.
Gets to the inside of Eddie Johnson. Makes the pass on Eddie. Eddie now lapped down. And now it is the 0-2. CE with pressure by the 51 of Kyle Busch. They both make it past the 57 of Eddie.
C.E. Falk runs in the second spot. Now he's able to get away from those two lap cars. Now Kyle Busch finds himself free and clear of those lap cars as well. So a little breathing room right now for your front three as they work their way through some of the lap traffic. A little bit of a gap right now before they get back into the heavier lap traffic here. Denny Hamlin, a chance to get that heart rate down just a little bit as they roll into turn number three. And this time by 70 laps have been completed, so 5 laps until the competition caution, and the battle for second is in turn number one.
Kyle Busch to the inside of the number 0-2 of C.E. Falk makes it look easy that time and moves up ahead of C.E., who drops back to third position. Peyton Sellers, Timothy Peters also in the top 5.
Yes, indeed. Kyle Busch now starting to stalk leader Denny Hamlin as Hamlin works around the high side of a slower car into turn number 3. Now Hamlin free and clear. Kyle Busch going to have to deal with that lap traffic as well. as they work off the final corner right now, as Denny Hamlin continues to set the pace here with Kyle Busch chasing him off that second corner.
Casey Wyatt goes a lap down the 92 machine, and here comes CE to his outside. Once again, it's Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, C.E. Falk, Peyton Sellers, Timothy Peters, your top five. Tyler Hughes is in sixth. Seventh is Brendan Butterbean Queen, Philip Morris in eighth, Justin T. Carroll, and Myatt Snyder in the top ten.
C.E. Falk has fallen off the pace just a little bit. Not so much that he needs to pit the car, but whether the tires have gone away, the handle has gone away on it. He has lost pace with the lead duo cars right now. He's dropped about 10 car lengths behind Kyle Busch and Denny Hamlin. He was all over Denny Hamlin here. So here's to see what C.E. Falk and the crew decide to do here with the tire change and what kind of adjustments they need to make. They were good in the short run, but over the long run now they've started to lose speed when compared to Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch.
Well, we've had four caution flags, and now the fifth is about to come out. Once again, it's the break here, lap 75, that a lot of these guys needed and wanted. They'll make some minor adjustments and also some tire changes as they're about to wave that yellow flag to signal the lap 75 break. And there it is.
Field all completing lap 75, and as soon as the last car rolled across the stripe, as Denny Hamlin was actually attempting to lap that car, the yellow flag did come out, and so we will get the field realigned. Pace car will pull out and pick up race leader Denny Hamlin, and then Alex Hayden from Motor Racing Network going to be busy down there because we're going to have pit stops and tire changes, and we'll see what kind of adjustments they make to the automobiles as well.
Hope he brought his Converse All-Stars. He's going to need it. He's going to be up and down Pitt Road.
He's got fancy shoes. He wears fancy shoes. Yes, indeed, he does.
We've got Denny Hamlin, once again, your leader. Kyle Busch in second. C.E. Falk, then Peyton Sellers. Timothy Peters, top five. Tyler Hughes is in sixth. In the eighth, then Brendan Queen. And you got Philip Morris, Justin T. Carroll, Myatt Snyder, top ten. Danny Edwards currently in 11th. Ruben Garcia is 12th. Nick Smith, 13th. 14th, Grayson Colliter. And Connor Hall in 15th. Matt Bowling, 16th, Justin S. Carroll, then Doug Barnes in the 88, Nicholas Sanchez, Mark Wirtz, top 20, Chase Cabrie in the 4, Eddie Johnson, Casey Wyatt, Colin Garrett, Mason Diaz in 25th, the 26, Chris Johnson, Ty Gibbs, Cody Carlton, looks like he's out, he was back in 28th, also Ryan Vargas in the 2, Fred Moffitt, he's still out there, Bubba Johnson is off and out in the 16, Terry Carroll, and Woody Howard having some problems earlier in the race on that lap 5 crash, and he's back in 33rd. Last chance to get the 50-50 raffle. Get your raffle ticket. You can win cash money. Also, tickets to the Richmond Raceway for Saturday night. $25 gift card to old school video games up for grabs from the fan club. Four tires and a minor adjustment is what you're able to do on this pit stop.
First line of business is the officials, the scoring officials, going to make sure that all the cars are in the proper order so that when they roll back out, we can get the field reset and set to go here. So that's the first thing. In pit road, and business will pick up down there with the teams making their adjustments and the time. Not really. I mean, we got Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch running at the front of the field. I think I'm fascinated by C.E. Falk because he was so stout in the first 30 laps or 35 laps, and then really our 50 laps of that stage, and then really fell off the pace a lot there in the last 10 laps or so. So I'm curious to see what the adjustments that they make on that car. I think another one that we've talked about him throughout it, Philip Morris now finds himself up in the 8th spot, kind of a reset for him now after an eventful first stage of this race. And if you're just joining us here on Fans Choice, or those of you fans that are here at Langley Speedway, Philip Morris started in the 11th spot on lap number 5, was involved in a spin over in turn number 2, went to the pit area, went to the back, and he has scratched and clawed his way up to the 8th spot. So I knew they want some new rubber on that race car, and Philip Morris kind of get a reset, going to start from the 8th spot. So we'll see what really having fun to watch. I don't know that there's any surprises, though. When you're talking about C.E. Falk and Philip Morris running well, that's not really shocking or breaking news when we're talking late models racing here at Langley.
So true. It is the two NASCAR Busch, Kyle with the most recent wins in the Monster Cup Energy Series for NASCAR, of course, and having a good season so far in 2018. driving the 18. So maybe it's this year since it's number 18.
We shall see, that's for sure. Right now, Kyle running that number 51 car, the Rowdy Bush number 51 machine, and right there in the second spot. It's going to be interesting to see. I mean, team orders, if you will. Those team orders work really well in the first 50 or 75 laps of the race. I'm not sure the final 50 laps, those things might go out the window, and not really. We've seen Denny and Kyle mix it up before on the Cup side, and who knows? They both want to win this race, so we'll see what happens. But right now, it's been pretty calm at the front of the field, and it is not calm on pit road. The pace car pulls the field down pit road. Slowly behind the pace car they go, and Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch and C.E. Falk and Peyton Sellers and Timothy Peters are
supposed to come in and be double file, but Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch and C.E. Falk all stayed up against the outside pit wall. NASCAR officials are trying to get them to go to double file. That way everybody pits. Here we go. Now we're starting to go double file. Everybody pits side by side to give everybody room to work and have it all happen right here on the front stretch in plain view of all of these NASCAR inspectors down here to make sure there's no monkey business going on. But I can tell you, you guys were mentioning C.E. Falk, how good the race car was, and it seemed to fall off. Keep in mind, they're going to put on four fresh new Hoosiers right now, but they will not be able to change tires anymore. So the handling went away on C.E. Falk's car after about 60 laps. They've got to go 125 more laps on this one set of tires. So we're going to see how that plays out. C.E. Falk able to come up with some kind of an adjustment or two to make sure that car's good on the long run. But Denny Hamlin, obviously pleased with the handling of his Camry. Kyle Busch was very patient. Decided to pace himself, figure out the tires, figure out what the NASCAR gives the green light. The crews all scamper around to their individual race cars, and they'll change these four tires and get them some minor adjustments on these cars as well. We're going to give away some money here in just a minute. The 50-50 drawing race. Money away here in just a couple of more moments. We'll pay this weekend for the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series race. That will be given away here in just a few short moments as well. A couple of the drivers have opted to get out of the race car. One of them is Peyton Sellers. Taylor Hughes is also out of his race car. And we'll see if we can grab a comment with Peyton Sellers as he is well, Peyton, we got 75 laps in this thing. How's that race car?
Man, it's pretty good tonight. I'll be quite honest with you. See, he's got a sporty car there, and you know, Kyle and Denny, they're pretty good, too. So I feel good about it. Me and Timothy had a good race there. And it's about putting laps on the board right now and trying to make a good adjustments right here. So I was a little bit too tight that run. The car was really kind of dicey getting down in the corner, and it shoved up a little bit. But at the end of the day, I think we can make some right adjustments.
120-plus laps on this final set of tires. How do you manage your patience with aggressiveness out there?
You know, you got to just try to get in lines. Looks like the bottom is kind of the preferred line right now in the restarts, and Maya was getting up there and making some stuff happen, getting in line, and you know, I treated that like a 75 lap race. I run it as hard as I could to see what it was going to do on that 125 lap run. So I think the tires are, you know, holding under us pretty good tonight.
There he is, Peyton Sellers, race fans. What do you think? Does he have a shot at this thing? I certainly believe he does. He's going to get a cold drink of water down here, believe it or not. Temperature 49 degrees, according to the thermometers here. The big problem, though, is the wind. The wind is whipping at about 10 to 15 miles per hour steady. I can tell you here, Philip Morris is out of his race car with the rest of his team as they work on the left front of that car. So I'll make my way over to Victory Lane as we get set to draw a winning 50-50 ticket. I'll throw it back up to you guys in the meantime.
Yes, indeed, Alex. Thanks down there. A lot of activity, a beehive of activity. So get those 50-50 tickets out. Get those 50-50 tickets out. And we're going to have that drawing here in just a moment. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, your top two. C.E. Falk, Hughes, runs in the sixth spot. Brandon Butterbean Queen. Philip Morris runs in the eighth spot. Justin T. Carroll is ninth. Myatt Snyder runs in the tenth spot. And let's see, I believe Alex may have the 50-50 drawing down there.
I do. We got Grayson down here. He's going to reach in and draw out the 50-50 ticket. $5,000 total, so $2,500 to the Denny Hamlin Foundation and $2,500 to this lucky ticket number. By the way, if you have the winning ticket, you need to take it over to the foundation fan club building. The fan club building right over here behind turn number one. So if you have this winning ticket in my hand right now, which the number is 0381034. 0381034, the winning 50-50 ticket number. Again, take it to the fan club building out behind turn number one to claim your $2,500. Now, we're drawing another ticket right now for two tickets to Richmond Raceway. Did you get a good one? Yeah? All right, two tickets to Richmond Raceway this weekend. So take it down to the fan club building if you've got this winning ticket as well. 0392069 for two free tickets to Richmond Raceway this weekend. A third ticket being drawn now for a $25 gift card to Old School Video Games. We heard from them just earlier in the evening. $25 gift card to Old School Video Games, winning ticket 0376505. 0376505. For that winning ticket. If you have any one of those three, take them down to the fan club building.
And I'd like to thank everybody that came out and fed Denny for just letting me be a small part of this. And we do it every Saturday night here. So I've been doing it for 20 years now. So, and I love it.
We love having you out here. Thank you. All right, there you go. I know that guy. Winning 50-50 ticket number drawn, $2,500 to somebody out there. If it's not claimed by the end of the next 75-lap stage, we shall draw another one. While it's quiet, want to say hello to our Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series driver, Eric Jones, is in the house. Eric Jones hanging out with us down here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. Gentlemen.
Indeed. Alex Hayden down there taking care of business, and I think we're down to about 3 minutes to go on the timer for this pit stop. While Alex was doing the 50-50, they'd given the five-minute call, and we see some teams out there with just traditional jacks, and then some teams out there with jacks and tires and wrenches, and then looking down, we see some teams with mallets going after them. So those are a little bit more significant adjustments, those teams that feel like they need to break the mallets out to get those cars fine-tuned.
It's not around a wedge, it's around a sledge, as in hammer.
No doubt about it, no doubt about it.
Pretty interesting to see them pitting next to each other like that, but I guess, you know, you got to do that when you got to do it at, you know, a space that doesn't allow for that. So that's pretty cool to see that, too.
Yes, indeed. With the 33-car field here, making sure that everyone has room to operate and set to go. NASCAR officials watching them walk down through, telling everyone to lower the jacks, and pit crew members are now being shushed. Shush being a technical term, of course, being shushed back behind the area where the cars are. And as a matter of fact, some of the cars roar back to life as we are set to go here for stage number two, round number two here of this one. This next stage goes to lap 150. 150, we will have another caution period where teams can work on the race cars.
And Steve, during that one, they'll be able to add fuel and make some minor adjustments, but that's about it on lap 50. Then we'll have a 50-lap shootout for the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown. A shootout at the showdown. You race fans having fun yet? I said, are you race fans having some fun yet? There you go.
That's what I'm talking about. Don't make me come down there.
Yeah, he will, too.
Don't make me come down there.
Yeah.
We get some of those redneck fries to get us through this thing. That's what I'm talking about.
Steve will come down there and steal your redneck fries if you don't make some noise.
That's right. Absolutely. About had some there pre-race. I couldn't get the lady to look the other direction.
That's some good stuff, though.
Oh, kidding me? That's fantastic stuff.
I mean, it's a good thing the track's not nearby my house, because I would be about 500 pounds. I'd eat that stuff every day.
Oh,
so good.
Gosh. Hey, well, so, okay, so now the folks here at Langley, you know what redneck fries are. Of course, there's a lot of people on Fans Choice TV tuned in. Redneck fries, you take the fries, okay, and they are fantastic fries. They'd be good just straight up as far as that goes. But then you put pulled pork barbecue on top of them.
Not just any barbecue.
Not just any barbecue.
No, Big Belly's barbecue.
Big Belly's barbecue, exactly. And if that's not good enough, you slather it up with some cheese. That's what I'm talking about right there. The redneck fries.
You know, Martinsville has their hot dogs. Yep. South Boston has their bologna burger, and we got our redneck fries.
Mm. And they are all very, very fine. Very, very fine racetrack food, that's for sure.
Now, do you like the Martinsville dogs?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Now, I'm not one of those 10 zillion a day guys,
oh, okay?
You give me two or three a day, and I'm perfectly happy. I'm not one of those competitive eaters, but I do enjoy a Martinsville hot dog or two each day while I'm over in Martinsville, Virginia.
And we got to get Richmond to come up with a specialty sandwich or something like that.
Exactly. If they need a taste tester, I know a volunteer.
Yeah, I know a couple.
Yes, indeed. We'll go up there and sample it up.
Well, Steve Post, once again, MRN, he's up here helping us out tonight. We got Alex Hayden from MRN down in the pits. Joe Moore's hanging out someplace. Joe was the smart one. He's up in a skybox somewhere having a cold beverage.
Which is not a phrase that is often uttered. Joe was the smart one, but I'm telling you, he figured it out this time, that's for sure.
Cheers to you, Joe. Jilly. Yeah, Budweiser, the official beer of Larry King Law's Langley Speedway.
I believe cars are now rolling off from pit road. We had one or two that needed a little bit of an assist. Now the push trucks are able to push out onto the track, so the pace car rolls off. And here we go. Fresh tires. Fresh Hoosier Bush, C.E. Falk weaving those tires back and forth. And this will be the last time they put tires on the car. So we went 75 laps on the first round. Going to have to go 125 laps on the tires, but they will be able to come in at lap 150 and make some adjustments to the automobiles.
Takes a good four laps for those sticker tires to get a really good grip, so it's going to be interesting. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, Philip Morris. Front row on the pole. Got a big old check, too. Ruben Garcia is in 12th, Nick Smith 13th, Grayson Colliter in 14th, and Connor Hall are your top 15 when we go back to green. And the cone is in effect.
And it is out now.
It is the car. Timothy Peters, one of those guys, along with Denny Hamlin in the 11. Tyler Hughes. I do believe that is Justin T. Carroll, 57. Ryan Vargas in the 2 also chose to use the cone on the outside. Down the inside, it's going to be Kyle Busch and the 0-2 of C.E. Falk. C.E. not afraid to mix it up with Kyle either. 26. And Peyton Sellers, 0-3. Butterbean, the 0-1 down on the bottom. First two races this season at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. If you're watching on Fans Choice, just to remind you, it's a .395 in beautiful coastal Virginia. You ever get a chance to make a trip and to the beach? Hot race in action. City of Hampton, also a big contributor of Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. In the city of Hampton, a beautiful place too.
Second stage set to go. Pace car pulls onto pit road. The Toyota Camry pace car, a pair of Toyotas on the front row. Let's see what happens this time. With Kyle Busch on the inside, Denny Hamlin choosing the outside. Denny Hamlin around the outside of the racetrack, able to take that lead back. Kyle Busch in second spot. Battle side by side for the third spot on the inside. C.E. Falk on the top side. Timothy Peters looking for some racing room.
A little tight over there between C.E. and Timothy Peters as they exit turn number 2. Directly side by side, door to door, as they close in on Kyle Busch, both at the same time in between 3 and 4.
C.E. Falk right there on the inside. Timothy Peters on the outside. Peters finally yields the spot. C.E. Falk. Kyle Busch says, I don't want any more of that. Third spot, Timothy Peters, he's not done. Peyton Sellers all over his back bumper as we've got one spun into the fence.
Caution flag out again. This is our fifth caution flag, not counting the one that we had for the lap 75. Pause. Not 80 laps completed. And did you see? It's hard to see. There we go. It is Eddie Johnson. I thought so. Eddie Johnson, the reason for the caution flag here on lap 80. And our sixth caution flag.
Eddie Johnson able to get that car fired back off and back underway now. So he will rejoin at the tail end of the field.
Doesn't look like he's got too much damage, but I do believe he is going to head into the pits and go to the attention of his crew and see what the problem might be.
I believe the way this thing is going to be scored is that Kyle Busch is going to maintain the second spot as the lap was not completed. C.E. Falk made the move, but the lap not completed. So Kyle Busch going to be scored in the second spot. C.E. Falk in the third spot. And Timothy Peters runs in fourth as we get things lined up and set to go back.
Of Kyle Busch. I think Kyle tried to use the outside. He tried to use like half that outside groove and then had the inside wheels on that inside groove that he had been using. But I think he tiptoed a little bit out of his range or comfortability, if that's a phrase. But he got passed, though, as soon as that happened, though.
It is a phrase now, so we've got it documented. So Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, would have been interesting to see. Would have been an interesting decision Denny would have had to make if C.E. Falk would have been the second-place driver.
True.
Because if indeed Kyle on the inside is cutting Denny a little slack, I don't believe C.E. would be of the same mindset.
I don't think cutting slack is in C.E.'s vocabulary. As it looks like Casey Wyatt's going to be the lucky dog, the CNU, number 92. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, C.E. Falk, Timothy Peters, Peyton Sellers, your top five. After 80 laps of competition, another break once again at lap 150, then a 50-lap shootout. Will an All-American NASCAR home tracks, and we invite you to check out your local track wherever you live in the USA. Got some diehard race fans here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. You would never believe this is a Thursday night, as many people that are here. We had to get some new grandstands over there between 3 and 4 to accommodate the people that we had scheduled to come here today. And we appreciate every single one of you race fans for being here tonight. All right, here we go. Timothy Peters. Once again, it's lap 80. Tyler Hughes, Ryan Vargas in the 2. Danny Edwards also on the outside. Matt Bowling in the 83. Heard much from Mark Wirtz tonight. He's been very fast the first couple of races we had. All right, here we go. Green flag is out. Here we go, Steve.
Indeed, racing down in the turn number 1-2, Denny Hamlin going on the outside, Kyle Busch right there on the inside. Now Timothy Peters gets up into the middle of it. As they're side-by-side battle.
24. There's a lot of damage on the side of that number 24 machine. And that is, once again, Mason Diaz.
That was right in front of C.E. Falk and Peyton Sellers. And those drivers, Tyler Hughes. And, man, I'll tell you what, that had to get their attention. And still, these lap cars with Timothy Peters is still working on that lap traffic. And that allows C.E. Falk to dial up the inside. They're side by side for the third spot. C.E. Falk challenging Timothy Peters. Peters able to take the spot back.
I think C.E. thought a little bit better about sticking it down on the bottom of the racetrack to let the 12 go by. Otherwise, that could have been a big mess. Pretty smooth looking for Denny Hamlin. He's got no traffic whatsoever, but you look at a turn four and you see Timothy Peters and C.E. Falk just ahead of a whole bunch of guys on the lead lap, trying to get around those cars that are a lap down, and it ain't easy.
That's a big old-fashioned mess is what that is, as they race into turn number three right now. Lap cars, lead lap cars, and these lap cars are pretty good race cars. They just got behind maybe by a dust-up or some kind of misstep on the racetrack, so it's not like the lap traffic is very slow. Lap traffic is running the pace of the lead lap cars, so that has given some of these guys some heartburn as they roll around trying to race four positions inside the top ten.
I just noticed up here on the scoring that Denny Hamlin turned in some of his fastest laps just a few laps, about 40 laps ago. And that was right after the tire change, of course. And that was around the average speed, 90 miles an hour. And that's the average. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, C.E. Falk, and Peyton Sellers, the top five. Justin T. Carroll, Philip Morris, Myatt Snyder up there in eighth, Nick Smith in ninth, and Tyler Hughes in the top 10.
11th spot is Brandon Butterbean's team. Danny Edwards runs in the 12th spot. Grayson Culliver runs in the 13th spot. 14th spot is Ruben Garcia. Nick Sanchez runs in the 15th spot. Dustin S. Carroll is 16th. Mark Wentz is 17th. Connor Hall is 18th. Matt Bowling 19th. And Casey Wyatt completes the top 20 cars.
21st, Eddie Johnson. Doug Barnes is 22nd. Then you got Chase Cavery, 23rd. Todd Gibbs, 24th. 25th, Colin Garrett and Chris Johnson. Mason Diaz, Cody Carlton, Ryan Fargus, and Brett Moffitt, the top 30. And Bubba Johnson, Terry Carroll, and Woody Howard.
26 cars remain on the racetrack. 27 cars remain on the racetrack. That means the final six cars are off the racetrack right now. Still just a lot of beating and banging here as this pack of cars races down into turn number one and two. Philip Morris is the lead car. Here's Myatt Snyder racing under another car. One of the lap cars there, the number 24 machine. And that 24 car doing a nice job out there with a lot of speed on it. And Mason Diaz, as Diaz now gets to the lap down. As they are just elbows deep in lap traffic. And some contact there a lap or two ago as they actually turn number four.
83, Matt Bowling makes his way down to the pits. Possible problem with the 83. Matt Bowling once again. And they look at, looks like the right rear on the 83 of Matt Bowling.
Bowling's crew works on that race car. Right now, Denny Hamlin just working on this race as he continues to set the pace. Now, while we've been talking about some other things, that Denny Hamlin has just maintained about a 10 to 12 car length advantage. That's one lap car between him and Kyle Busch. There goes Kyle Busch by. Timothy Peters has an advantage now over C.E. Falk at about 6 or 8 car lengths. C.E. Falk runs in the fourth spot. He's still got Peyton Sellers a couple car lengths behind him, so your front five stretch.
Well, you've got Peyton Sellers and Justin T. Carroll breathing down his neck. And that is for the fourth position.
Lap 142, 143 now as Denny Hamlin flashes across the stripe. So seven more laps, and we're going to go caution again. This stage has been very, very caution-free. I think we had one early, and then we've gone pretty straightforward right now as we're six laps from the end of this stage.
Good battle there between Nicholas Sanchez and Ruben Garcia that you were able to see on Fans Choice TV. Denny Hamlin, though, once again, as he's maneuvered the lap traffic perfectly so far. We'll have some more here shortly, but for the minute, he's in a safe zone.
That's a great spot about being out at a racetrack. Right now, Denny Hamlin not under challenge for those positions, but I am telling you, at the racetrack, There are battles all the way around this speedway. You look up in one corner, and there are two wide, three wide sliding off the corner. You look in the other corner, and there's lap cars and lead lap cars all racing for position. Awful exciting to be out here and watching these races. This is the battle right here for position number five. Peyton Schellers has it, but Justin T. Carroll down on the inside. Carroll has rolled forward in this one, and he is challenging Sellers for the fifth spot in the turn number three. A great run for Justin T. Carroll.
Those cars pretty much even as far as speed goes, but Justin T. Carroll not giving up down on the inside, and neither is the outside. A great back-and-forth battle between these two as Peyton Sellers not going to let that machine get by.
Again, bonus money at the end of this stage, so bonus money coming up in three laps, two laps, actually, and that's what you're seeing, and you just don't want to give up the spot in the second half of a race. You don't want to give up the spot at all because that's someone you're going to have to race in the final 50 laps. Denny Hamlin slides off from turn number four, down to complete lap 149. Hamlin has been so strong in this one all the way through as he's on the back straightaway now, working his way toward the third turn as we get ready to complete stage number two.
I got a feeling if Denny doesn't win this race, he's going to be mad because he's led so many laps. And he knows how to get around this racetrack. He'd like to prove it to everybody, even though he's been away for 20 years.
Yes, indeed. Great racing all the way back through here now as they roll down across the stripe. And indeed, there it is. The yellow flag is out, and that will bring it to an end, stage number two. Denny Hamlin picks up the victory here, or picks up the lead, has the lead at the end of stage number two. Kyle Busch runs in the second spot. Timothy Peters is third. C.E. Falk runs in fourth. And Peyton Sellers is your top five.
So Denny makes a little money for his foundation by being the leader here at lap 150. Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, C.E. Falk, Peyton Sellers, your top five. Justin T. Carroll, Philip Morris, Myatt Snyder having a great run tonight here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. Nick Smith in ninth, and Tyler Hughes in the top 10.
Brandon Queen runs in the 11th spot. Danny Edwards runs in 12th. Grayson Colliter runs in the 13th spot. Nicholas Sanchez is 14th. Ruben Garcia runs in the 15th. Justin S. Carroll runs in the 16th spot. Mark Wirtz is 17th. 18th is Connor Hall. 19th is Casey Wyatt. And Doug Barnes in the number 88 car runs in position number 20.
Ty Gibbs in that 18, 21st. This Chase Cabrera in the 4 in 22nd. 23rd, Eddie Johnson, Colin Garrett, and Mason Diaz, top 25. Let's go to Alex.
Matt Boley, you guys mentioned, came in early out of the car. Matt, what put you out of the race?
Yeah, we have some rear end issues, man. We got way tight right there, and felt got to vibrating pretty bad in the rear. So just fight some mechanical issues right now, I think.
That's Matt Bowling out of the race early. Bad vibration at the back of the race car. Some sort of a mechanical gremlin has put him out of the race early.
Thank you, Alex. Alex Hayden from Motor Racing Network. Of course, you can hear Alex on MRN.com. Doing practice shows tomorrow. I believe Alex may be on the qualifying broadcast as well, and we'll be calling, I believe, the turn tomorrow night in the Xfinity Series.
That is correct.
Yes,
yeah.
Indeed.
Correct on all accounts.
Wow, that's rare. Boy, that's a phrase you don't hear that often. And then Alex Hayden on pit road Sunday night or Saturday night at Richmond International Raceway. So you can check us all out at MRN.com, Motor Racing Network, and good three nights of racing here for Alex Hayden and yours truly. Joe Moore is here as well, and we wouldn't have it any other way.
We're so lucky to have you guys stop by and help us out tonight, not only with the broadcast, but just seeing you guys and have you experience what we do here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. It is the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown presented by Toyota. And I see the moon up in the sky with a big smile. You see that?
Yes, indeed. With a big smile, too. Big smile, too, and you're at a racetrack, that's for sure.
I think the moon's looking at those redneck fries.
That's right, exactly. Well, as long as we look up and see the moon smiling and not look down in the pits and see Alex Hayden mooning, I think we're all right.
There you go.
Yes, we don't need that.
Much, much too cold for that to be happening right now. I'm telling you guys, I don't think anybody down here is comfortable because the wind is absolutely whipping at a steady one of the pit boxes down here has a little weather system put on it, a mechanical system, and the wind gusting upwards of 27 miles per hour, but a consistent 18-mile-an-hour wind here with 46 degrees currently.
Yeah, it's good for those jets across the street over Langley Air Force Base, but not so much for the race cars.
Well, here they are. They have come down the pit lane. The crews are ready to go. They cannot put tires on these cars. They can, however, make other adjustments to their machines. So we'll see what, if any, adjustments get made to either Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, C.E. Falk. We'll see what happens. The NASCAR officials not letting the teams to the race cars as of yet. They want every car parked and stopped and engines off before they allow all crew members to get out there and get to work on their race cars. Not yet. The drivers staying inside the machines. The window nets are staying up for the moment. A couple of the crew members trying to jump the gun a little bit early, and the officials tell them, nope, get back behind the line as we get every car parked and all the engines turned off before they will enable these crew members to jump out there. I can tell you, a couple of the jacks and some jack stands are ready to go, which means there's definitely going to be some adjustments to some of these front-running race cars out here to see exactly what happens on those. We'll stay tuned on that. But they're also going to add some fuel to some of these machines as well. This is a 125-lap run that they've been having to make. 75-lap dash here in stage number two is complete. So once the NASCAR officials give the okay, the crews will snap into work here on the pit lane. And that happens as I speak. Here they go. Crew members all now going to their respective race cars. Looks like everybody's going to add fuel to the machine. C.E. Falk's team is going to put the jack under the left side of the race car. And, well, no, they're not. Officials came up and talked to him and said no. They are not allowed to jack these race cars up, apparently. There's some of these other teams back here are trying to do the same thing, but we saw some NASCAR officials say no on that. But it looks like they may be allowed to do so. It's kind of a difficult interpretation because some officials are saying, no, you can't do that, while some of these other teams are going ahead and doing it before the NASCAR officials get there. But you know what? That's part of it. You get what you can get before they tell you no.
Yeah. Ask for forgiveness, not permission.
There you go. Absolutely. Lots of activity down there, Alex, as they continue on and continue to work on these race cars. I believe once they got started, it was a five-minute clock, so not a lot of time to work on these cars.
Well, Steve, I noticed you were on Twitter a while ago. Anybody talking about the race here tonight?
They're talking about the race tonight. Yes, they are. It's great to see. We've seen this a couple of times this year. We see it a lot of times when Kyle Larson and Casey Kane is out racing and when Kevin Harvick was out at Bakersfield Racing. And we see a lot of activity on social media talking about what's going on here. The good news is, you can be on social media, and there's a whole bunch of people all around the planet sitting at home wishing they were here, and then the rest of us were here. Yeah. So we win that battle, that's for sure, because as much fun as we have on Twitter and other social media platforms, it's far better to be at the Speedway, at the Larry King Law Langley Speedway, for sure.
We had people here this morning, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. They were rolling in, and usually the crowd that we saw this afternoon around 3 o'clock would be what we would see around 5 o'clock, and then it fills up usually on Saturday nights around 6:30, 7 o'clock. But that was done by, I'd say, 4:30 or 5 today. Great day, and plus on a weekday, too, on a Thursday.
Yeah, great big crowd. The front grandstands here are totally full. They brought in extra grandstands down through 3 and 4, and those are partially packed as well. So a huge crowd on hand here.
Hey, guys, I can give you a follow-up on what's going on with some of these teams that are getting jacks underneath the race cars. You're not allowed to jack the car up where the tires come off the ground. You can jack it just enough to raise the body to get adjustments made on these race cars. So a little confusion with some of the race teams down here, but the NASCAR officials have done a nice job making sure everybody understands what the exact rules are. I can tell you, see, team, they're going to work on both the right front and the left front of the race car, making chassis adjustments there, as Kyle Busch has got a little bit of scraping down the right rear quarter panel of his black Mobile 1 Toyota, where he's kissed the wall very gently. But his crew chief, Marcus Richmond, also the car builder of this machine, leaning in the window, they had the light on there and gave the tire temps to Kyle Busch, and now he's going to be able to give his feedback on what kind of adjustments they want to make to their Toyota Camry race car as well. Denny Hamlin's team, all they did was add fuel. They're very happy with the handling of that race car, obviously. It's been an absolute rocket ship here in this race, especially here in stage number two. So adding fuel only to Denny Hamlin's car.
Understand it was a broken axle on the 83 from Matt Bowling, and he's usually up there running up front. Denny Hamlin will try and get his victory here at his home track 20 years ago.
and, of course, his foundation, the Denny Hamlin Foundation. It's lap number 152 up in lights, and a big shootout shaping up here, Steve.
Yeah, it's a matter of who made what adjustments and who saved what during that stage there. We still have 50 laps on these tires, so 75 laps on them have been completed, so we've got 50 to go. And I'm just fascinated. We saw some drivers drop back a little bit, and just wonder if they drop back because of ill handling or drop back just being patient. Well, the drop back time is over now, and it's go time here. And we're going to see what happens in the final 50 laps and just see who did what, who makes adjustments here, who saved a little bit more tire out of those Hoosier tires. And it's going to be fascinating to see who does what. Now, Denny Hamlin had the advantage, though. When you're running up front, you can set your own pace. And as long as no one is pressuring you, you can ease the car down in the corner. You can baby those tires a little bit better. So I would dare say Denny Hamlin probably in pretty good shape here. As we look at the tires, and Alex had talked about the wind, watching the flags on the flag stand hang on to those things. My gosh, it's moving out there.
Yeah, we've had some wind gusts come through here today. First one was when we had that cold front come through this afternoon. Temperature dropped like a rock, and the winds kicked up, and stuff was blowing around. People were putting their jackets on, and then about 15 minutes later, it calmed down. It got really quiet, and it was still cold, but once again, the winds have picked up. We appreciate you race fans sticking through it. I know a lot of you, once the caution flag came out, you got out of the grandstands, went down to warm up a little bit, and they're about ready to fire them up again. So head back to the grandstands as we close this one out in the final 48 laps at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway.
That's a hearty grandstand here, that's for sure. It's a big grandstand full of race fans and everybody here on a blustery cold night. And we do appreciate, on behalf of the Denny Hamlin Foundation and everyone here at Larry King Law, the Langley Speedway, we do appreciate all of the fans, every one of you being here tonight and enjoying. And I can't imagine what these last 50 laps are going to be like. This is going to be fascinating to watch this one unfold here tonight to see who wins the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown.
One thing's for sure, up for you. It's like we're your very own personal trainer.
That's right.
Ends of the racetrack at the same time a lot of times. All right, they'll get them all lined up here. C.E. Falk, Peyton Sellers once again up there. First two races this year at Langley, Myatt Snyder. A lot about Mr. Snyder, son of one of your colleagues.
Yeah, Myatt's a good kid. Marty Snyder, you can catch Marty on NBC Sports. Marty does a great job covering here, Marty now, and watch Marty now doing the IndyCar stuff. And of course, he'll join us in NASCAR up at Chicagoland coming up later on this year when the tour moves up there and NBC takes over their portion of it. And Marty Snyder does a great job, and his son Myatt, been watching Myatt race since the Bandolero and Legends cars down at Charlotte Motor Speedway. And it's good to see Myatt get an opportunity driving a limited schedule in the Camping World Truck Series with getting some rides along the way and getting out here and running his late model car as well. So Myatt Snyder doing a nice job here as well, doing a great job here tonight. So great to see Myatt Snyder out here and another one of our young, talented drivers climbing the ladder.
It is Richmond Raceway action this weekend, the Dash for Cash Xfinity Series. That's Friday, April the 20th. And then you got, of course, the Toyota Owners 400 for the Monster Cup Energy Series, or the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series. But it's going to be a fun time in Richmond. Dale Earnhardt's going to be in the Xfinity race next September at Richmond. And he was talking about doing some in-car reporting. But during green flag conditions, not under the yellow.
Yes, but we have a friend in attendance tonight that is probably at the beer stand that has actually already accomplished that at Richmond, but I don't know that anyone talks about that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, someone got in trouble. Joe Moore and Carl Edwards had a conversation under green at Richmond a few years ago.
Okay.
Yes, indeed. you could hear heads exploding all over the sport. Yes, indeed. So, but I would never say anything about that at all. So,
well, of course not.
Yeah, I
we'll keep it between ourselves.
Heard the Dale Jr. download, and I heard him talking about he wants to do it under green, and I'm sitting there, been there, done that. We did that on Motor Racing Network a few years ago. And
yeah.
Let's just say the Cat in the Hat, Jack Roush, was not a happy man. There were some other folks that were a little twisted up as well. But it was good. I just love it. I think Steve Letard is going to be his crew chief for Dale Jr., and it's going to be some fun stuff. It really, truly is.
Yeah, and his spotter, he's going to try and work a deal to get his spotter back, too.
Yeah, TJ Major is trying to get his spotter back. So that's good stuff.
Man, one thing I love listening to is TJ Major's call a super speedway race.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
that is entertaining.
Yes, it is. So many talented people in NASCAR. We talk about the drivers all the time. We talk about the crew members, but the spotters that do some amazing work atop the spotter stand, and sometimes in some rough conditions, that's for sure. So, but they do a great job, that is for sure. And speaking of a great job, we're set to go back after it. The cone has been pulled out, and we are set to go. And again, Denny Hamlin choosing the high side. Kyle Busch down low. Now we'll see where those team motors go here in the final 50 laps. And we have got Timothy Peters, C.E. Falk in the next line.
They're about to turn them loose for the final few laps here for the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown presented by Toyota at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. Thursday night action. And here we go. Kyle Busch, Denny Hamlin on the front row. Denny wants to win so bad at the track that he got his first win on. Larry King Law's Langley Speedway green flag.
Denny Hamlin gets his own on the outside, able to drop down in front. That's what we talk about teammates here at the front. Timothy Peters part of that team as well. So it is a three-car teammate. Oh, my gosh. Great racing there, but C.E. Falk. Looks like he had to bail out on that one. Or maybe taste the concrete over there off of turn number two. Now he's got a track to the first spot.
Timothy Peters looking for a way to get by, but meanwhile up front, Kyle Busch comes to life as he starts to put the pressure on Denny Hamlin.
Oh, big hit over in turn number two as we had a car spun around right up toward the middle of the pack. And a huge, huge hit as I believe that might have been the eight car was the first car to go around. Tyler Hughes, I believe, was the first car to go around. A long, lazy spin. And in came Danny Edwards. And that long, lazy spin became a big old crash over in turn number two. And so red flag is out here right now as a heavy hit over in the second corner.
Nicholas Sanchez also got a piece of that, along with Danny Edwards, our pole sitter for the event today. And he got an extra check for sitting on the pole. He might need it to replace some of the parts on the number 26 Chevrolet. Once again, we have, I think, our seventh caution flag. Nicholas Sanchez comes into the pits with a lot of damage. Alec Hayden is there. He'll get a look at that and let us know exactly what the deal is. But I think his deal is done for the night, looking at all the damage on the right side.
Yeah, a lot of damage on that car. The right front fender is gone. It's sometimes you see a damaged fender. There's no fender at all. And unfortunately, that is going to be, it looks like, the end. And just watching the repair work over in turn number two, and we see some more of the drying compound. I'm not shocked. That was a big hit over there when Edwards bailed it off in there. I mean, it was big contact over there, so not surprised that there's some fluids rolling down across the track as we've got a little bit of a mess over there as the tentacles of fluid roll down into the inside of the speedway.
Yeah, guys, I not in the middle of the pit lane. I'm actually out here in turn.
I think he's in turn two. He's just
close
on the
eye on these drivers down here. Pole, one of the drivers involved, as you guys pointed out, and he's already out of his race car. As a matter of fact, both drivers out of the race car right now, talking to each other about exactly what happened. We'll grab a word with both of those drivers here in just a moment.
Alec Hayden in the pits, also on the track, wherever he needs to be. And Steve Post up here with me, Mike Allen, as we call the races for you at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway on a Thursday night. And looking at about 10:42 as the time. So it's been a fun night so far and still a lot of racing left. Not too fun for Danny, who was up there on the pole looking good the early stages of the race and gets caught up in someone else's spin and ends up with no place to go.
CarMasters Automotive, an ASE Blue Seal certified Napa Auto Care Repair Pal Top Shop. All makes and models, 2-year nationwide warranty and fair price guarantee. Rental loaner cars open until 8 p.m. weekdays and 6 p.m. Saturday. Improve your car's position by bringing it to CarMasters or your race car's position with CarMasters Automotive, proud sponsor of Langley Speedway's Cone. CarMasters is hiring master technicians, state inspectors, and service advisors. Call 757-456-0722. CarMastersAuto.com. 931 East Little Creek Road in Norfolk. CarMasters Automotive.
For over 50 years, Whelan Engineering has researched, designed, and built the finest visual and audible warning products for police, fire, and emergency medical services, towing, and Department of Transportation professionals. Whelan takes pride in creating edge technology designed to keep you safe. Whelan Engineering's headquarters are located in Chester, Connecticut. Every Whelan product is designed, manufactured, and tested in the USA and is supported by knowledgeable product engineers as well as a customer service department committed to getting products out the door as quickly as possible. Whelan Engineering Company is a proud American manufacturer of emergency lights and warning sirens. These systems are used by law enforcement, fire, rescue, EM out the USA. As you look around the racetrack tonight, you'll see the lights on pace cars, support vehicles, and racetrack signaling devices that have been designed specifically by Whelan Engineering. All Whelan products are proudly made in the USA, and Whelan Engineering Company is a proud sponsor of Langley Speedway.
Greg Edwards, driver of the 97.3 The Eagle, Danny's Glass, late model stock car at Langley Speedway.
Just pick a driver, pick a car, and just root for them and see how it works out. You know, so it's a fun time, and you'll learn it as you go. But a lot of hard times, some crashes, and sometimes, you know, you can see some good side-by-side racing. So I'd come out and check it out. It's fun, you know, to have one this close to us and one as big as Langley Speedway. Langley Speedway is known nationwide. The people at NASCAR really feel of Langley Speedway is really up high. I mean, it's the 66th year running, and, you know, it was 65 in a row. We had to take a year off. So I think it's really cool that that Langley's back open. It's a, you know, all the biggest names in the sport have run at Langley, and I just think it's cool that we've been able to run good there, and I think anybody should come out and check that out.
Visit Greg Edwards Racing on Facebook and see him on the track this season at Langley Speedway.
And what you saw happen with Danny Edwards, one of the reasons that Greg Edwards chose to sit out this race. And he's got his eye on a bigger prize at the end of the season.
Yeah, guys, I've caught up with our pole sitter. Unfortunately, happened out there on the racetrack.
I really don't know. I think there was a lot of crazy driving going on that restart there. And we got three wide back here on the back stretch, and a couple guys started shoving under the bottom, and then I think the 12 got into the 8 down there, and then do it. So we're pretty much destroyed, but is what it is.
That's certainly a tough break. Tyler Hughes also involved crash.
Guys. Danny Edwards once again with the Chevrolet, sat on the pole, got a big check once again, and that will go towards the race car, it looks like. Well, we've got lap 151 up in lights as we go back to the last full completed green flag lap. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch up front, Timothy Peters, and C.E. Falk, Peyton Sellers. Danny Edwards was up there in 12th position when he got caught up in that wreck. Tyler Hughes and the number 98, Nicholas Sanchez, all involved in that most recent caution in turn number 2.
Tyler Hughes, you mentioned one of the drivers involved in the incident. He, too, has made his way back to the infield. Tyler, what happened out there from your vantage point?
Well, you know, it was a kind of a wild restart there. We went down into one, and Mike got up a little bit and out of the groove, and I tucked up underneath him, took it three wide, and came out good. Went down into three and just gave Nick a little bump, and man, he just drove it down in there and just clear took us out. I mean, I thought it was pretty dumb, you know. I didn't think it was a respectable payback. I mean, I would have, you know, liked a little tap or something, but, you know, when you throw it down in there that hard, you know, spin us out, and then we get our nose taken off by somebody else. It just sucks. Had a good race car tonight and was out there riding, and that, you know, after we got four tires and felt like we had a really strong car to you know, bring home a top five, maybe not a car to win, but definitely a top five car tonight. And it's just a shame that someone's got to be as stupid as he is.
Up until the...
Oh, man, it was really good. It was a lot of fun, you know, a lot of mixing it up, just getting track position. And then, you know, the second segment there after we got the tires, you know, I was just sitting back riding and, you know, just trying to get the best exit I could and save my tires. And I felt like I was doing a great job of it. And then just sucks to be taken out like that.
No question about it. Frustration in here for Tyler Hughes and Danny Edwards, both of them out of the race. Hey, and we'll go back with Tyler.
Just like the, you know, thank my Simpson Racing product, Safety Clean, and my whole team for being behind me. We struggled here a couple weeks ago, and we really worked hard to be back out here. Big shout out to Sellers Racing and Jay Hedgecock, and we had that thing on a roll tonight, and I'm truly appreciative for everything my team has done for me, so thank you.
Well said. Definitely. That's Tyler Hughes, guys.
Postman, you know what I love about that interview? Honesty.
Honesty. Yeah. No doubt about it. He, no doubt about it, not happy at all. And, you know, I just kind of called it, said he got into him, and said he would have liked, he might even minded a little bit of a tap down there, but then it was a little bit more than that. And then I think that was some the spirit of this event. It's the big stage. It's the big time that you get a chance to perform on a Thursday night with the eyes of the entire racing world here, and you put in such a good run, especially after struggling a few weeks ago. And he talked about his crew, and I think that's one of the real, just the beautiful things of short track racing and grassroots racing is, you know, we talk about the pit crews and the guys and gals that work on the cars in NASCAR. There's a lot of guys and gals that work on the car in this thing, but they're doing it out in the shop behind the house after dinner on a Tuesday night and Wednesday night and Thursday night, and they scratch their heads like Tyler talked about, and they try to get the car better and try to get the car better, and you come out here and you put in a respectable run, and then all of that pride, all of that satisfaction of all the hard work that all your volunteer crew has put into it with one move kind of goes all the way. So the good news is with racers, Tyler Hughes and his crew, they'll be back in the garage working on the car and trying to get back out here for the next one.
Let's go to Alec again. Go ahead, Ed.
Yeah, Nicholas Sanchez also out of here. What happened out there from your driver's seat?
I was just hung up on the outside. I got tight, and I just had nowhere to go. I got car clipped me and just messed up the whole right front.
Up until this point, though, Nicholas.
So, I mean, you could kind of hold the outside. You could hold your own and almost pinch the guy on the inside off.
And Nicholas Sanchez, he's okay. The car, not so much, but the California native will be back to race another day.
Alec Hayden once again. He's down in the pits. And Steve Post, once again from MRN, up here in the booth with me, Mike Allen, as we give you the action here at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. And a big old shootout shaping up as we have lap 152 up in lights. Or 151, they go back to the last green flag completed lap.
Have one car stop down between turns 1 and 2, so we'll get a push truck over there to get that car fired off. And we will then... see where we're at as far as who chooses where and when we get set to go for this one. And like I said, I don't know that I think it's been a little gentlemanly at the front of the field, but I think we're getting closer and closer to that time where gentlemen's agreements are going to go out the window, and it might be a little bit of an arm wrestle or wrestling match out here at the front of the field. And if you're sitting there, if you're Timothy Peters, if you're C.E. Falk, if you're Peyton Sellers or Justin T. Carroll, I think you need to keep an eye on everything up front, because I talked about it just listening to those drivers that wrecked the car. They said right on that restart, the intensity had gone through the roof on that restart, and no reason to believe that that's not going to be the case when we get back to green here momentarily.
Good friend of ours here at the racetrack, KP Harrell. We call him Hook. He used to say when it got down to the intensity level, he'd say, "Lights out at the reptile house."
That's right, exactly. Yep.
And that's exactly what it's about to be. Denny Hamlin goes by, Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, C.E. Falk, the number 26 of Peyton Sellers. Philip Morris, he has quietly worked his way back up after that lap 5 crash. He's currently shown in the 7th position. Justin T. Carroll, another driver that's come along the past couple of years here at Langley Speedway, and has gotten faster and faster, and he's up there in the top 10.
Going to choose this time. The cone has come back out onto the front straightaway.
It is the Car Masters cone. Who's going to take it? I think, will get his lap back. So Denny Hamlin will be on the outside. Timothy Peters as well. The 57 of Justin T. Carroll. Down on the bottom, it's going to be Kyle Busch. The 02 of C.E. Falk. Peyton Sellers. 01, Philip Morris. Some talent down there on the bottom of the racetrack.
Yes, indeed. The Car Master cone being pulled away, and we will set to go. I believe the track caution lights will be extinguished this time. As a matter of fact, there you see them go off on the Toyota pace car, and we are set to go back after it here. Kyle Busch going to be on the inside, but Denny Hamlin choosing the high side for this one, and see what happens. C.E. Falk down on the inside with Timothy Peters on the outside. Peyton Sellers out there as well with, Justin T. Carroll has chosen the high side of row number three. So stay tuned. Going to be interesting to see what happens. 151 laps have been completed, 49 laps to go.
I'm a little nervous about that spot in turn two. It's right there in a good spot where they start to get on the gas at the exit of two. Let's see what happens as the green flag flies. Kyle Busch, Denny Hamlin up front.
Denny Hamlin on the outside, Kyle Busch down on the inside. Hamlin gets a run around the top of the speedway. Let's give Denny Hamlin the top spot. Kyle Busch is there, and C.E. Falk is right on the back bumper of Kyle Busch. Busch runs in second. C.E. Falk to his right elbow is Timothy Peters.
Timothy Peters caught on the outside, but he's still applying some pressure to the 0-2 of C.E. Falk. And every time we've had a restart, Denny Hamlin on the outside, Kyle Busch down low. It looks like the same old movie at the exit of two every time as the 11 is able to clear him. But here comes Kyle Busch fighting back on the inside.
Yes, indeed. As we're down in the final stages of this one, who saved what? Who has the best for the end? Right now, your front five cars have broken away. Trouble turn number three. We've got him around. Justin T. Carroll spins around. A couple cars slide by. We've got a couple cars crashing in. One with a fender up as Justin T. Carroll got slid around. They were side-by-side battling for position number six. I believe Philip Morris might have been on the inside. Justin T. Carroll on the outside. Carroll just got in there, and it swapped ends on him. And a couple other cars got caught up down there in turn number three.
Both Justin T. Carroll and Justin S. Carroll involved in that big wreck. Also the 88, and he had just got his lap back, I do believe.
Boy, a lot of damage on that four cars. He's just come down to the attention of the crew and the entire of Chase Cabry's crew. The entire left rear fender is just gone off from that car.
And Justin T in the 57.
He's got some steam coming out from under the front of that car as well. So not sure if his night might not be over either.
Going to need a little push for the 88.
Again, back under red flag and more fluid down on the racetrack over in turn number three and four.
We would like to thank our wreckers in towing, Lighthouse Towing, Tidewater Express, and Pete's Towing, always helping us out here at Langley Speedway. And they got a little bit of stage ride they need to take care of over in between three and four. They've gone through some stage ride tonight, that's for sure.
Yeah, wouldn't mind the stage ride concession here tonight. If sold it by the bag, I think you'd be all right. I think you'd have a pretty good night at the office here. They've busted some radiators and put some other fluid down on the race cars. So a lot of work going to need to be done over there in turns three and four.
There's Alex.
Yeah, Justin T. Carroll, his car beat up down here. He's just gotten out of the race car. We'll grab a comment and find out exactly what happened out on the racetrack. Good, solid effort up until this point. What happened out there?
I don't know. Racing hard there at the end of the race. You know, had a really good car all day, really. And felt like we had ourselves in a pretty good contention there to, you know, be there at the end and just kind of buying our time. And I don't know if the two just got in there a little too hot or what, but just door slammed me and spun us around and sitting there. And I don't know, someone got the front end of it, but this racing sucks 2 weeks in a row, but we'll get it fixed and get back out there.
Yeah, frustrated, no question about it. Heavy right front damage. Also, it's got the radiator punctured down here. A lot of suspension damage on the right front, but frustrated young racer John Carroll. He'll be back, no question about it, but I think for the second time in as many crash guys, they have pointed to the same driver that happens to still be in the race.
Yeah, how about that? There we go. Business is picking up indeed.
Doug Barnes once again in the 88, and he is out of the race. He was up there in 17th. Other drivers include Mason Diaz, Justin Carroll, Justin T. Carroll, and yeah, what a big mess. Looks like they're getting cleaned up pretty good, though, over in between the turns of 3 and 4. The weekly races can be seen after tonight. If you'd like to watch a replay, the video replay for 2018 is always on Vimeo.com/Langley Speedway. That's V-I-M-E-O. Video on demand. It's Vimeo, V-I-M-E-O. Check it out. Also live lap-to-lap scoring. If you'd like to keep the Race Monitor app available at the App Store and Google Play. And, of course, you can always listen live on the track frequency at 100.9 FM because once the cars get going around in circles, sometimes it's hard to hear the PA unless you're in the skyboxes or you got that radio in your ears listening to us. And, of course, you can always use that radio for MRN broadcast this weekend up in Richmond.
Looks like crew members continue to work down there on the racetrack in turns 3 and 4. Pace car, as a matter of fact, rolling off now, so back underway.
I got a feeling the top two guys leading the race for the most part today, Denny Hamlin and Kyle Busch, will be the top two guys at Richmond as well.
Very well could be. There's no doubt about it. The Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch are two of the best that Richmond has right now. And when you look back 6 or 8 years ago, the Gibbs cars were just things have equalized a little bit, but I don't know about a lot. And they're just so good at racing at Richmond International Raceway. And, yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if we're not looking at both these drivers maybe mixing it up here tonight and mixing it up again on Saturday night over at Richmond.
A couple other guys to keep your eye on up there at Richmond, Clint Bowyer and Kevin Harvick, both with wins this year.
Yes, indeed. Going to be a fascinating race to see who does what. And third short track race in the last 4 weeks. And we'll see how they fare up there at the old fairgrounds track at Richmond. And just going to see who does what. But you're right, the Gibbs cars have been good. Kyle Busch and Denny Hamlin, very, very talented at that racetrack. But I'm fascinated to see what the Penske cars do. I'm going to be watching and see what the Penske team does. And then, you know, just some of the stories we've been covering this year. Ricky Stenhouse Jr., they're feeling pretty good about themselves after a great run. Top five or even a little bit better this weekend. And Jimmy Johnson, although Richmond has not certainly been one of his better tracks, but comes off a fourth-place run at Bristol. So a lot happening in the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series world. And but I think to your point, Mike, when we get down to it, if I was going to Vegas and putting so much money on the line, I don't know what I'd put much against Denny and Kyle when it comes to Richmond. They're both pretty good at that track.
Man, it sure was a great Bristol race, wasn't it?
Oh, my gosh, what a great race. It really was. Just some fascinating racing. Just an outstanding race. Kyle Busch picked up the win, his second consecutive win. But the old Bristol is back, and lots of folks happy about that. And it was just a great, great, great weekend of racing, interrupted by the terrible weather. The only consolation is we're getting used to terrible weather, except for this weekend at Richmond. We're going to be fine, and maybe this will put us in the right direction in the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series season.
There you go. All right. Well, let's see. It looks like every lap coming at the exit of turn two, yeah, Denny is able to get by Kyle Busch easily. But I think Kyle's on to his trick.
I think so, too.
He's going to have to get a really good start
without jumping the start on Denny.
Track caution lights have been extinguished. The field is set. Double file formation behind the Toyota Camry Pace Car. Pace Car leads them off from turn number two now onto the back straightaway here at the Larry King Law, Langley Speedway. Pace Car is starting to pull away just a little bit. The black Toyota Camry of Kyle Busch on the inside, the race leader. The control car is Denny Hamlin. The white Toyota Camry on the outside. 153 laps have been completed.
All right, Denny drives the FedEx car. It is time to deliver as we get down to the end of this one. Green flag again here at lap 153. All right, here we go. This is where he gets him every time. And again, he pulls ahead at the exit of two.
Denny Hamlin gets the advantage into turn number three. Kyle Busch now right there, and they're side by side for the next few rows back through there as the 0-2 car of C.E. Fulton is on the inside of two.
Oh, spin! The 20 goes around. And a big pileup down on the bottom of the racetrack. Some cars going through the grass to avoid the crash. And the caution flag is out again.
Ironically, all the cars are pulled away.
Yeah, I think that was the 26 I was talking about. And that, of course, is Peyton Sellers. All right, so they say, the officials, the next caution flag that we have after that, the laps will count. So if we have one more after this one, they'll start counting those laps. So they're going to stop them, line them up, and then the cone comes out, it all goes out the window.
Yes, indeed, exactly.
Yeah.
Just working right now to get them lined up. They were side by side, so scorers going to look at the lineup. And looks like the front four cars are in fairly good shape, and now it's just a matter of getting the balance of the field. And these are some of the cars that were involved in that dust up over there in turn number two.
A lot of guys did a smart thing, though. Rather than plow through it or try to get on the brakes, they just went down in the grass. Yeah. And avoided a lot of mess. It also kept the track a little bit cleaner than it would be. So that's pretty cool. Denny Hamlin continues to lead over Kyle Busch, C.E. Falk, and Timothy Peters. Next is going to be Myatt Snyder in the two. He's going to be up there in the top five. Actually, the 26 is up there, Peyton Sellers. Now, he did spin around, but then there was a big crash behind him.
Guys, Ty Gibbs got a big piece of that crash out there. The entire nose of his red and white Camry is completely caved in. They threw some... just pulled away box down here to get back out on the racetrack, but... no water down here. That's a good sign. It means the radiator's intact after the heavy nose damage, but they're going to have to really get some more tape on that. I'm not so sure those three pieces of duct tape are going to hold that whole front end together. So pay close attention to that. Let's hope it does hold.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Let's hope that does. That's for sure. So, again, the field is now set side-by-side formation as we are getting ready to go back to green flag racing action.
And they will turn them loose in one lap. And once again, if we have another caution flag, anything after that, they will count those yellow flag laps. Denny Hamlin, Kyle Busch, C.E. Falk, Timothy Peters, Peyton Sellers. And once again, Kyle Busch down on the bottom. And we've seen this movie before. Denny Hamlin on the outside. Timothy Peters, officials telling all the spotters that the next time they have a caution flag, those laps won't count. And here we go, green flag once again. Peyton Sellers, top five. And they get
once again. Gone down the back straightaway. CE sticks his nose underneath Kyle Busch for that second spot. CE coming to life.
Indeed, CE Falk has stepped up his game. He's on the inside of Kyle Busch. Kyle Busch on the high side. CE Falk down low as they race their way. Give CE. Now, Peyton Sutton. Peyton Sellers call.
Peyton Sellers still digging at the exit of turn. As Kyle holds him off on the outside on the four.
Yes, indeed. Kyle Busch. Two spots. Now Philip Morris tries to. Fox in that transaction.
Kyle Busch back to fifth position. You're on Peyton Sellers, number 26. But meanwhile,
2010, CE Falk used up Denny Hamlin. Good spot. Here comes. And Kyle Busch says, thank you, Mr. Peters, for opening the door. He follows.
As he closes up and puts a little bit of pressure to the 12. The third spot.
Busch up. Side by side. Peters gets the run down into turn. Peters wheel to wheel off turn.
He made that, make that move and still up there in the top five in that 26.
Now a car like that ahead. His race car. Did he save the right amount? We'll see. Stay tuned. Now Denny Hamlin back.
Catch that back bumper on CE Falk. Denny, back 20 years ago, Larry King from the inside, Steve.
Yes, indeed. Denny Hamlin trying to. Remember, 2010, CE Falk used up Denny Hamlin. And reverse, CE Falk.
168 of 200. Counting. And once again, CE in the lead. The KCI. Once again, it's Denny Hamlin, and he is a Carling.
Hamlin runs in seconds. We got Timothy Peters, and we've got Peyton Sutton. Challenge earlier on, as it sits right now. In front of your leaders is CE Falk, continues to pace the field.
That's able to come back after being shoved. That's in third spot.
Yes, indeed. He's been rolling good. It was more like a lap and a half. They caught the back of that field. Our CE Falk able to get that spot, keep moving up. CE Falk in the second corner. Boy, he has crowded him down. Number three, CE Falk, able to continue on working through the lap.
Hamlin comes back to life, and the number 11, he's next to CE, makes the pass at the edge of the four. That was.
No doubt about it, found the opening there as CE Falk.
Diaz. I'm not sure if that might have messed up a little bit. Saved a little bit more than C.E. Falk did.
Lap 176 of two. Determined to win this race. Three car lengths make it four. Five car lengths ahead of C.E. Falk, who's continuing to fall back into the clutches of Kyle Busch in the 51, who's closing in fast. And Kyle, he still might have a chance to get up there and battle it out with Denny.
Yes, indeed. Kyle Busch has really cut down the distance between him and the race leader. C.E. Falk was the race leader. Kyle was a full straightaway back. He's a half a straightaway behind Denny Hamlin now. Of course, C.E. Falk is between the two of them. But right now, Kyle Busch, the fastest car on the racetrack. He's in third spot. And we have got 21 laps to go.
Great battles all over the racetrack, a little bit further behind, but Denny Hamlin leads. C.E. Falk and Kyle Busch, Timothy Peters, Peyton Sellers, your top five. Philip Morris, Ruben Garcia, Myatt Snyder, Nick Smith, and Justin S. Carroll, the top 10. Butterbean's just outside the top 10 in the 0-3, having a quiet night tonight, but hanging in. He's to the outside of the 77 of Connor Hall as we speak, and Connor makes the pass and tries to between 1 and 2, and now does on the back straightaway.
Yeah, able to make the inside work as takes that spot away off from turn number two. At the front of the field, Denny Hamlin continues to be the race leader. Kyle Busch has caught C.E. Falk. Falk is in the second spot, but Kyle Busch is on a mission. He's on a tear up off the second corner. Kyle Busch looks to the low side. We'll see what happens. A little lap traffic ahead. Oh, C.E. Falk going to set the pit. No, Kyle comes right up the gut, making it three wide for the second spot.
Impressive. With force, Kyle Busch gets past C.E. Falk. C.E. got into Kyle to make the pass for the lead and get up there and battle it out with Denny. And now the roles are reversed as Kyle Busch comes back, makes the pass on C.E. Falk.
Now Denny Hamlin as a marked man with Kyle Busch right there. Denny Hamlin working through some slower traffic has about 6 to 8 car lengths on Kyle Busch. As they race their way up off the final corner, we're down to 15 laps to go, and Kyle Busch is the fastest car on the racetrack.
He saved his car, did a great job. Every time that Denny wanted to make the pass on those restarts, he let him go. So, yeah, he might have been saving something.
Kyle Busch not necessarily used to these late model stock cars. Most of his short track stuff is in the super late model cars. So, but he is Kyle Busch after all, and able to figure it out very, very well. We'll see now as we roll through the final laps of this one. Denny Hamlin is the leader. Kyle Busch again locking off lap times, locking off times quicker than Kyle Busch, just 3/1000ths quicker that time. So Denny Hamlin has been able to pick up the pace just a little bit.
Lap 187, and here's Butterbean with a challenge. He's got the 22 up his tailpipe trying to make the pass. Kristen Culliter. And Culliter down on the inside at 0-3 of Butterbean back in the field. Another good race is between the number 12 of Nick Smith, the 77 of Connor Hall. And the 0-0 is a little bit off the pace on the back straightaway.
Yeah, we'll see if that car can get down on the apron, and indeed it does. And the margin continues to shrink. We're down to a half a second margin, which is about 3 car lengths. Denny Hamlin's going to have to drive a flawless 10 laps right now as they work their way in on some lap traffic running side by side. And Kyle Busch is there. It's 0.4 seconds.
Chris Johnson, meanwhile, pulls it into the pits. But, yeah, you're right. They're racing side by side just ahead of the leaders. And it's a tough battle, too, between the 22 and 0-3. They continue to lean on each other. The move-over flag was displayed, but... yeah, it's going to be a little tricky as Hamlin goes to the outside.
Hamlin goes to the outside and Kyle Busch is there. It's down to a car length. It's down to a half a car length. Now Hamlin takes a left-hand turn, works to the low side of another lap car. Kyle Busch going to have to follow him through this time.
Great battle up front as Kyle Busch comes back to challenge his teammate Denny Hamlin in the number 11. Meanwhile, Mark Wirtz has made his way into the pits in the 55.
A little bit of an open track right now. We're going to have 3 or 4 laps of open track. Kyle Busch able to go a half a groove lower than Denny Hamlin up off the second corner, but Hamlin keeping it wound up on the high side, able to get that momentum into 3. Kyle is there again. Kyle's looking low off turn number 4.
Denny rockets out of turn two and four with a lot of speed, but Kyle Busch trying to finesse his way past his teammate, the number 11, the FedEx machine of Denny Hamlin. And again, closes up right to the rear bumper. They're trying to get around the 0-1. Peyton Sellers is off the pace now.
Five laps to go. They work around the outside of another car. Another one of the automobiles. We're down to 4.5 laps to go. Denny Hamlin has some lap traffic in the windshield and has Kyle Busch in the mirror there. Four to go, and Denny Hamlin now stretching it out to about 2 cars.
Hamlin using the lap traffic wherever he can to gain some ground on the 51 of Kyle Busch, but Kyle Busch not giving up, still closing in, and now within a car length that time, but once again, like you said, Denny stretches it out.
Denny awful stout up off in the corners here. Kyle gets down in the corner and kind of through the center of the corner, but Denny gets a good run up off the corner there. Turn number two, added turn number three. This time by, the signal goes out as they come off turn number four. Two laps to go for Denny Hamlin. Traffic ahead, Kyle Busch behind.
It's getting a little tight once again as we get down to the final laps of the race. The white flag is going to be displayed to the windshield of the 11 of Denny Hamlin. Kyle Busch still chasing down, closing in as fast as he can, and some lap traffic will come into play, it looks like.
Kyle Busch looks to the low side. Denny Hamlin is the leader. We're under the white flag into turn number two, up off from turn number two into turn number three. Hamlin sets that Toyota down to the inside. Kyle gets there. Can he do anything? No, he cannot. Denny Hamlin wins the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown here at Larry King Law. Langley Speedway. Hamlin picks up the win, gets a tap after the race from his teammate Kyle Busch as Denny Hamlin goes to victory lane here tonight.
You know he wanted to win so bad you could see it, and the determination he had after he got passed by both Kyle Busch and C.E. Falk, and we saw him come back to life and get in the gas and really go for it, and it paid off as Denny Hamlin wins the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown presented by Toyota. What a race. We will get a word with Denny in just a minute. Race fans, we thank you so much for joining us on a Thursday night. We know it's been cold. We know it's been windy. But we thank you so much as the celebration will happen now on the front straightaway with Denny Hamlin driving the FedEx machine and getting that victory and that checkered flag.
The Autos by Nelson team putting out a strong effort here and going to victory lane with Denny Hamlin. Hamlin picks up the win. Kyle Busch second. Timothy Peters third. It's a 1-2-3 finish.
What an awesome job. Awesome race by Denny Hamlin.
He's burning the hides right off that thing.
He's burning.
He's going to leave all the rubber right here at the front straightaway.
And he's leaving us a little racetrack tattoo on the front straightaway.
The only thing wrong with that is little.
Yeah, not little.
Man, that thing is just smoking. Wow. There he is. Ladies and gentlemen, Denny Hamlin.
That is cool. He's not done yet.
Stuff it in the fence.
Yeah. The thing's a little hot. It's going to be a big celebration in the Dale Lemons victory lane for Denny Hamlin. Our winner tonight in the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown at Larry King Law's Langley Speedway. And we'll send it down trackside with Alex Hayden. He'll get a word with our man, Mr. Denny Hamlin, after 200 laps.
Denny Hamlin, first time driving a late model stock car here at Langley Speedway, puts it in victory lane. The helmet is off. The Hans device coming off now. The earpiece is just about to pop out. He's got to get the helmet disconnected. And seatbelts now coming off for Denny Hamlin. Hey, race fans, put your hands together. Here he is, Denny Hamlin. A huge, huge win and a nice cold drink. Denny Hamlin, congratulations for the second time you've won the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown. Well, give us an idea how this race played out for you tonight.
I'm glad my name was on the race. Otherwise, it could have got a little dirty there at the end, but it was so fun to have a car that drove this good. You know, got to thank everyone, the whole Nelson team for giving me such a great car. David did a great job. David Triplett did an amazing job working on this car and getting it where it was a race winner. So pretty easy to drive. I knew that me and Kyle were playing a little cat and mouse in the second stage there, trying to save tires. I knew we were going to have to race eventually. It wasn't going to be that easy, but it was great to come out with a victory. And thank for FedEx and Toyota for their support of this event. Thank the fans for such a great turnout. Just really happy.
Well, give us an idea, the early start of this race. How much were you having to save the tires? And then once, after you put the four fresh tires on at lap 75, how quickly did you go in the tire conservation mode?
Yeah, once we got there to about a five-car length lead, I was just trying to back off and save the tires, but it looked like Kyle would back just as much as I would there. Like I say, it was a big cat and mouse there to try to save tires, and obviously we had the best tires there at the end. So it was I tell you, it's a great event. Can't thank all the competitors also for preparing the race cars. I know they got shows that they probably got to run this week, but can't say enough for everyone. All the teams, all the sacrifices that the wives and girlfriends and husbands make for these team guys to come out here and make this happen.
On behalf of all the race fans and all of us here, and especially the competitors, thanks for keeping short track racing alive and doing all you can do to do it.
Thank you. Couldn't be prouder, and look forward to seeing everyone back here next year.
There you go, folks. Denny Hamlin, the winner of the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown.
Did you just hear what he said? I like that.
Yeah, had a pretty good ring.
Had a pretty good ring to it, didn't it? Denny Hamlin picks up the win, scoring the victory. Kyle Busch finished in the second spot. Timothy Peters was third. Fourth spot was C.E. Falk. Peyton Sellers was fifth. Myatt Snyder finished in the sixth spot. Justin S. Carroll finished in the seventh spot. Ruben Garcia was eighth. Connor Hall was ninth. And Nick Smith finished in the tenth spot.
11th was Grayson Colliter. Then you had Ty Gibbs, 12th, 13th. Brendan Queen, Philip Morris, 14th. And Casey White in the top 15. Colin Garrett in 16th. Eddie Johnson, 17th. Mason Diaz, 18th. 19th, Mark Wirtz, Chris Johnson in 20th.
Finishing 21st was Chase Cabaret. Justin T. Carroll finished in the 22nd spot. Doug Barnes was 23rd. Tyler Hughes, after that crash, 24th finisher. Danny Edwards was 25th. Nick Sanchez was 26th. 27th was Matt Bowling. Cody Carlton was 28th. 29th was Ryan Vargas. Brett Moffitt was 30th. Rounding out the field, Bubba Johnson, Terry Carroll, and Woody Howard. The 33-car field here tonight at the Langley Speedway. But Denny Hamlin, the man of the night, the man of the hour in victory lane.
Congratulations, Mr. Denny Hamlin. You did it. You came back to your home track 20 years ago. You got that victory. We're all proud of you and glad of what you do for the Denny Hamlin Foundation. And once again, we want to thank our Grand Marshal today, Eli. And, of course, all you race fans for coming out. Well, Postman, I had a blast up here with you in the booth. It's been an outstanding night of action and a lot of fun up here, too.
I'll tell you, Mike, I love going to new racetracks and checking out places, and I had high expectations of coming here to Larry King Law Langley Speedway, but the expectations were surpassed by the facility itself and your setup up here and the great racing action. So always a thrill and great to get to a new racetrack and great to be part of this event with Denny Hamlin, the Denny Hamlin Short Track Showdown. Always fun, and sounds like from what Denny said, maybe we'll get a chance to do it again next year right here. So great stuff. It's a pleasure being here. We appreciate all of the MRN fans.